Falter of Huiganomi, Huiklika Kanish, Huiga Olaf, Huifi is the Hena, their Donegal, Agus Dede. Fernier Barkinish, Agus Yedre La Tusakar, Huihisha. Welcome to Oma to the Ulster Under 21 football final between Donegal and Derry on this 5th of September evening, the evening of the Ireland hurling final. First of all, apologies, there's no programme on sale here, and therefore there may be certain confusion about the Derry team, which I'm not familiar with. The referee, the camera now focusing on the Donegal team, on the Donegal defence. Well, Donegal attack, it is Seamus Meehan there on the ball, into the corner there where Paul Carr is. Paul, number 13. Not a very big crowd here for this Ulster final. The Under 21 Championship, possibly in its last year, with the reintroduction of the Junior Championship coming next year. Running along there is Sylvester Maguire, unfortunately out of the Donegal team with injury. Second time this has happened to Sylvester, happening him in the Ulster Minor Football Championship last year. And the game is on, and in it goes, and up they go. And it comes out to Seamus Meehan. Seamus is fouled, a free for Donegal immediately there. A foul by McGuckie and on Seamus Meehan, taken quickly by Martin McHugh to Joyce, but it's cut off there by Liam Devlin. Liam Devlin away down here to number 12, Kieran Quinn. Kieran Quinn fouled, and immediately referee Cranny exercising his authority here. And the free is taken quickly by Eugene Murphy into the corner there. The Terence McGuckie and getting it in low. Coming out there between two, Ronan McCusker sending it in there, and Matt Gallagher coming out for Donegal. Matt getting it away over on the far side there, dropping through, and it's number five again, Liam Devlin. Liam Devlin for Derry, moving the ball up the Derry forward line, playing all over the place, not keeping positions. Okay. Line ball for Derry on the far side. Going high there now is Ronan McCusker and Matt Gallagher. Matt breaks it down to Brian Tuohy. But the ball has gone out, and it's a 45 metre free for Derry. One can notice, of course, that the Oma pitch here is very, very big. One of the biggest pitches in the country, the St Enda's pitch in Oma, which would be probably a disadvantage to the Donegal boys, not used to this kind, the size of pitch at all. This free being taken by Eugene Murphy. Eugene Murphy for Derry. In she goes, dropping on the edge of the square ball, and it's a free out for Donegal. 2 minutes of the game left, no pattern established yet. And here it comes up to Joyce McMullen and Seamus Meehan. Seamus now on the ball for Donegal, getting it into the corner there. Pádraig Gallagher coming out. Pádraig, beautiful ball inside to Seamus, or to number 15, Paddy McGroarty. Back again to Pádraig. Pádraig outside there to Seamus Meehan, running for the ball with Barney McNabb. Barney McNabb gets it for Derry and sends it down the side of the field. Ronan McCusker. And so referee Cranny blows and gives it to Derry. Is it? In she comes there, and the shouting, and Matt breaks it down to Tommy McDermott. Tommy shouldered off the ball there. Joyce McMullen coming into it. Joyce, good long ball inside to Paul Carr. Paul takes it well, tackled by a man, sends it outside there, but the pass is intercepted by the McNabb. McNabb for Derry, sending the ball away up to the side of the field where it comes to Kieran Quinn, running there with Brian Tuohy. Brian Tuohy gets the better of him. Brian moving it up again to Martin McHugh. Martin again being fouled by Paul McAllister, and again a free for Donegal. The referee blowing up anything going. Martin on the ball again after a short free by Eunan McIntyre. Martin inside there. Good ball to Anthony Malloy. Anthony tackled there, can't get round. Sends it inside to Quinn. Quinn getting the ball away now to number 9, Damien Barton. Damien, one of Derry's big men, sending the ball upside there now, and it comes to 11. McIlhinney away out now on the far side of Terence McGuckian way out on the right with number 15. And he get round there, still has the ball, gets it outside to number 14, McNichol. McNichol, long, high ball into the parallelogram. Up goes Kelly, and it's a goal! It's a goal! It's a goal, and once again, Donegal's suspect position there, goalkeeping position, Michael Kelly going up there with Matt Gallagher, and total confusion and a big, high, harmless ball going into the net, and so Donegal find themselves a goal down. And so now Donegal have it all to do. Up goes Anthony Molloy for this one, breaks it down, but again it's Derry getting the better of it there. A free for Derry, Sean Mackay being fouled there. 5 minutes of the game gone. And so a very unfortunate defensive error there, letting Derry into the lead. But again, it's another Derry man on the ball. McCusker, or number 14, is McNichol. Out it comes this time to number 11 on the Derry team, McIlhinney. McIlhinney away out here, and again they're getting round, and Mickey McBertie in a bit of bother there. Terence McGuckian, and Terence high and cross the goal and wide.
Come on, Derry goal!
Come on, Derry goal!
So goalkeeper Michael Kelly placing the ball after that unfortunate start. Certainly a very, very bad mistake between the two of them. And the second involved was Matt Gallagher, who's now taking the kick out. Matt's kick comes into the middle of the field. Up they go, broken down by Charlie McGoal to Eunan McIntyre. Eunan McIntyre, a ball here for Paul Carr. Paul Carr, down he goes on it. He still has it. Up on top of him there is Mickey Convery. Mickey gets the ball out of Paul's hand, and Mickey fouls him, and it's a free for Donegal. This free is 55, 56 yards out. Charlie Mulgrew seems to be going to take it. Donegal not having settled at all so far in this game. Now Martin McHugh is going out to take this one now. It's a very long free. It must be 57 yards now. Martin trying to gain 1 yard there, but it's certainly very barely pointable free. Martin taking his customary long run at it. There he goes, fine free kick by Martin into the square. Up goes Pádraig Gallagher. It seems to go off Pádraig Gallagher. It hasn't gone out. Yes, it's a 50. It's a 50 off a Derry defender, and so Martin now will have a chance to point this one. Six minutes of the game gone. A 50 for Donegal. Martin McHugh the taker, number 10. Terry number 7, Paul McAllister there in front of him. Martin sends it away right in again to the edge of the square. Well fielded there in the Derry defence by right back McNabb. McNabb sends it away out, and across goes Tommy McDermott. Tommy fields it well there. Sends it away out left to Shimmy Meehan. Shimmy on the ball. And again to the corner to Packy McGroarty. Patrick McGroarty trying to get room. But the Donegal team is not moving the ball quickly enough so far in this game. And it now comes to Liam McIlhinney. Liam McIlhinney moving the ball inside to Damien Barton. Back again to McIlhinney and McNichol. Lose it between them. And it's Joyce McMullen on the ball now. Joyce is fouled, and another chance for Donegal. Donegal coming more into the game now, but not moving with enough fluency as yet. Martin going over again to Martin McHugh. This one well inside the 50. And so Martin moving back for this 50 for Donegal, who are a goal down. This is a fine free by Martin, and it's gone wide, but it's gone veered wide again at the last moment there. And so Donegal, despite that recent pressure, still down there by one goal to no score, with 7 minutes of the game gone. Goalkeeper John Mackill placing the ball for his own kick out. John's kick coming out beyond the 50. Up goes Anthony Molloy, breaks it down, and it comes down to Shamie Meehan. Shamie twists, turns, holding the ball. Then the kick is blocked down well there by James McGuckie, and coming out loose on the left-hand side now to Sean Boner. Sean Boner getting it out here to Charlie Mulgrew with Damien Barton. It wasn't a good ball and Damien has it. Damien still has it. Moves inside, crossing it there now. And Eunan McIntyre and McNichol. McNichol gets the ball, but he fouls Eunan McIntyre. A free for Donegal to be taken by Sean Boner. The Derry forward line moving all over the place, which means that Sean Boner is way out now in the middle of the field. The kick rather central going there to Joyce McMullen. Joyce and Quinn. Confusion again. Martin McHugh on the ball. Tackled heavily there. Comes to Pádraig Gallagher. Pollock fouled, and another free for Donegal. Donegal getting plenty of frees, but no scores as yet. Martin again coming to have another go at this one. This will be Martin McHugh's fourth free. This one outside the 50. They've all been reasonably difficult frees. So a 51-yard free kick for Donegal taken by Martin McHugh. In front of the goals, this one more central than any of the others. And again, Martin lifts it up well. This one seems to be better. It is, and it's a point for Donegal. A fine point by Martin McHugh to leave the score after nearly 10 minutes of the first half. A goal for Derry, a point for Donegal, and that point scored by Martin McHugh. Scoreboard there beyond the goals on the other side of the field. John Mackell is not taking this kick out. It's been taken by right back McNabb. Barney McNabb for Derry. Coming into the centre of the field, and up goes Patrick McGroarty, taking it well, the Mount Charles man. Away out to Joyce McMullen. Joyce of Four Masters. Big Sunday last from Sunday for Joyce. He's going through in a run this time again. Still has the ball. Tackled by McNabb. Joyce isn't he doing well, and he's not fouled. Up goes Paul Carr, pushes it down. It's still in there. A chance for Donegal, but across it comes, and the Derry defence is going to get it away. It's McNabb again being hassled there by Martin McHugh. McNabb gets it over to the far side to Matt Gallagher. Matt Gallagher and McNichol going for it. McNichol gets the better of Matt this time. The Ballantra man still at him. McNichol getting it away, however, and this time it's going to McKay, broken down by Brian Chewy. In goes Charlie Mulgrew. Charlie on the ball. It's in Eunan's man now, moving it up, but well brought down there by Murphy. Now it's Mulgrew again. Still Mulgrew. Lovely ball inside to Shamey Meehan. Shamey Meehan coming now, but again slowing it down a bit, and comes inside and is intercepted. And out it comes, a free for Derry for a foul there on Paul McAllister. And here come Derry now. Long ball going down there into the big open space. Going back for it is Brian Chewy. Brian Chewy gathering a good, intelligent short ball there. But, oh, Tommy McDermott fails to get it. Comes to Liam McElhinney. McElhinney, the long ball inside there with Mickey McBertie coming out along Terence McGuckie. And Mickey being fouled there by McGuckie, and a free out for Donegal. 11 minutes of the game gone. A free for Donegal. It's to be taken by Mickey McBertie himself. Mickey's kick coming out there towards Matt Gallagher, but it's going to beat Matt Gallagher and McNichol. Dermot McNichol, the Derry full forward, and it's a line ball for Derry. Most of the spectators here this evening are from Donegal. High hopes for this Donegal under 21 team, but at the moment they're in arrears. Quinn, long ball inside, up they go in there for it. Comes down to Brian Chewy trying to get it away, does get it away, going across to Paddy McGroarty, but again your man Quinn at right half for Derry having a fine game there. It's Liam Devlin there. Tommy McDermott getting the ball away. Martin McHugh and McAllister, and again it's another Derry man getting this ball, getting it away across to Terence McGuckian. Terence McGuckian on the ball, sending it inside there now to the centre half. James McGuckian up it goes there, and the ball breaks down. And it seems to be Mickey McBertie trying to get out with that. He's under pressure. He still has the ball. No, it's Sean Boner sending it away now for Donegal to move out. But Anthony Malloy, can Anthony get it left? He finds it difficult. He's being fouled. He still has the ball. He does get away. Good football here by Donegal now. Charlie Mulgrew moving the ball quickly to Pádraig Gallagher. Pádraig Gallagher moving it back again. And forward again. Lovely football by Donegal. Their first move game, but it comes back there now, and there goes the shot, and it's a shot, and it's gone wide from Matt Gallagher, away up an attack. Donegal moving the ball about there, but in a vital moment decided to come back instead of keeping going forward. John Mackill placing the kick now for the kick out. He's going to take it himself. Donegal most of the play, but still 2 points down. A dark, somber evening here in Omagh. That broken ball again, it's Damien Barton. Damien Barton sending it across this side where it's Kieran Quinn running for it. Can Kieran Quinn get it? He's being tackled by Eunan McIntyre. Quinn gets round McIntyre. Quinn, the long ball inside there now with Tommy McDermott trying to get it. Tommy takes it brilliantly there for Donegal. And the Ballyshannon man to another Ballyshannon man, Brian Toohey. Brian Toohey, good ball inside there now to Joyce McMullen. Joyce getting round his man. Joyce and another run, foul and a free for Donegal. For a free on Joyce McMullen. Joyce taking it quickly himself to Seamus Meehan. Seamy moving in, and again a poor ball there, not giving Joyce any chance at all, but here it comes to fullback Fergal Moore. Fergal being foul as he comes out, and it's a free for Derry. Again Donegal moving well to the 50, 40, 30 and then running into a certain difficulty. Moore's kick is coming up this side to Quinn. Eunan gets in well. Eunan McIntyre. Martin McHugh himself now. Martin gets it well up. Send the ball back to Charlie Mulgrew. Charlie sells a dummy. Sends a good ball inside to Eunan McIntyre, but a Derry man comes across there. Mickey Convery. Convery still has the ball. Convery holds it too long. A chance for Martin McHugh to score a point for Donegal. This free kick for Donegal is from about 40 yards out, well within Martin's range. Good harassing there by the Donegal defence. Martin McHugh taking this free for Donegal. And again, Derryman pretty near putting Martin off. That up goes Donegal forwards, but again has gone wide. And Donegal have their chances in this game, but they're not taking them so far with a quarter of an hour gone in the game. John Mackill taking the ball for the kick out. Going to the left there, Joyce McMullen going up with Devlin. I think Devlin wins that ball. He does win it, and it's a free kick for Derry. Referee Mick Cranny of Down well up with the play. Leaving the ball down to Barney McNabb to take this free for Derry. Not a happy trend for Donegal, having enough of the play but not converting it into scores, and then the defence shown to be a bit suspect there in the goal mouth. This ball comes down, Ronan McCusker inside, or it's Ronan McCusker on the ball now. He takes it's blocked down there, and it's a 50 for Derry. Yeah, you're okay. This 50 going to be taken by Eugene Murphy, Derry's number 8. A run there by number 12, Kieran Quinn. More runs by the Derry forward line. But Eugene Murphy goes for the long one. In it goes, but it seems to be going wide. It's gone wide, and it's a kick out for Donegal. 16, 17 minutes of this game gone now, and it's one goal for Derry, 3 points for Donegal, and Matt Gallagher to take this kick out. No, it's Mickey McBrearty to take this kick out. In it goes, and up goes Eugene Murphy, unopposed at midfield, fouled, and a free for Derry. Going to be taken by Liam McElhinney. Liam placing the ball now, standing over it. And once again, Derry will probably go for the one into the goal mouth or over the bar. It's on the 50-yard line. In it goes, and it's dropping there again to the edge of the square. Drops down, and a well-taken point there by Eugene Murphy. And it's 1-1 for Derry, 1 point for Donegal.
Come on, Donegal!
18 minutes of the game gone. Mickey McBrearty going to take this kick out. Mickey from the Four Masters Club, one of the stars of last Sunday's championship victory. Referee Mick Cranny pointing out that the ball should be placed in the middle after a score, directly in front of the goals. Mickey's kick out going to the left-hand side of the field, and it's Joyce McMullen. Joyce playing well for Donegal at the moment. He gets away from Kieran Devlin there. Joyce is going again. This is a typical Joyce run now. Porra Gallagher coming out to give him the room. Joyce still going. Is Joyce fouled? No, she's tackled hard there. Porra Gallagher has it now. Porra takes a shot, but it isn't strong enough and it's going wide. And once again, it's another wasted chance for Donegal. Lacking decisiveness up front, the Donegal forward line so far. John Mackell taking the kick out. In it goes to the middle of the field and up they go. And it's blocked down this time by Anthony Malloy. Martin McHugh. Martin still on the ball. Martin being hassled. Martin getting that left foot shot in. And it's once again gone. Donegal wasting a lot of chances in this game. Martin there getting moving but failing to convert it into scores. Fairly even game so far. As John Mackell places the ball now for this kick out to be taken by himself. Looking around there, we see this is a very tall Derry team, particularly there in midfield with Murphy and Barton, where, as we see, but Anthony Malloy goes up there and gets it well, comes through, the referee gives advantage to Donegal, their advantage doesn't really accrue, and it's another free kick for Donegal, 48 metres out, and again Martin McHugh going across to take it. Martin placing it again, gaining a yard there, the referee coming out to have a look. He lets him away with it. He's now, no, the referee is speaking to the Derry man who is putting Martin off with some of these kicks. Seamus Meehan tries to obviate that Derry advantage by distracting the man. Martin's kick this time long and once again same side of the goal and it's gone wide. Martin not on song today in these free kicks. One of them scored but the rest not, and it's still 1-1 for Derry, 1 point for Donegal. John Mackell, the taker of the kick out. A Derry goalie. So 20 minutes gone. Out comes this kick again. And it's Damien Barton blocking the ball down. James McGuckian sent it up. And Brian Chewy. Good ball this time to Shamey Meehan. Shamey. Again, a ball into the space. Kieran Devlin and Joyce McMullen. Kieran gathers it, but Joyce takes it well. Joyce trying to get through. Joyce must be held. He still has it. He takes a shot in, but again, it's not a particularly good one. John Mackell out to the left there, and this must be Anthony Malloy's ball. One-handed. Anthony does well. Still has it. Ball fortunately drops out to Brian Chewy. Brian trying the big high ball in again, and John Mackell has it. Takes it well and sends it out again. Here and up goes Anthony this time. Will Anthony manage it this time? No, beats him. Brian Chewy. Brian doing well for the third time in a row. Brian being tackled a few sides. Gets the ball out well there to Matt Gallagher. It was a dangerous ball. And it's another free for Donegal. This free again on the 50, but the Derry team making sure they fouled him there about the 50. And Donegal's place kickers not really finding their mark so far. They've changed now and Seamus Meehan is going to take this free. I think it's Shamey. No, it's Porrick Gallagher. It's Porrick taking it. Porrick's kick is again going in but doesn't go over the bar. It's coming out towards the saint. And it's Martin McHugh going for it along with his marker. And in goes the boot once again for number 7, Paul McAllister. There must be a bit of dissent there. The referee brings the ball forward 14 yards, leaves it a pointable free kick for Donegal. On Martin's right left foot. Left foot, but to the right side. And again, the referee now talking to number 7, McAllister, who once again is pretty near Martin's free. This distracting tactic being used a fair amount by the Derry team. This kick is a better one, but again, it doesn't come in. And again, Donegal have wasted another chance. It's been a woeful litany of missed chances in the first half by Donegal. One of these things that happens on occasions like this, that a team that has put so much into it and so far on the final day, things don't seem to be going that particularly well. John Mackell's kick out into the middle of the field. Damien Barton, Anthony Malloy. Anthony takes it well there in the big Ardoram and is fouled once again. persistent Derry fouling, not being punished at all by Donegal. And again, Martin to take this one. Derry conceding away at freeze, but Donegal not capitalising. Martin McHugh taking this one again. Paul McAllister again just in front of him. Referee calls him back. Martin's kick this time is over the bar, and it's another point for Donegal. And so, after 28 minutes of the first half, it's Derry 1-1, Donegal 2 points, both frees by Martin McHugh.
Come on, Malloy!
It's actually 24 minutes. It's 24 minutes of the half gone. Up goes Patrick McGroarty, but he only brings it down for Damian Martin. Damian Martin, the long ball into the open space. Beating Mickey McBrearty there. Mickey going back with Terence McGuckie, and Mickey slips. Terence has it. A chance for Derry. Terence McGuckie and cutting in. Still cutting in. Trying to get round Tommy McDermott. Still going. And he sends it wide. A let off for Donegal there. Free out, or the goal kick out now. Mickey Kelly, Michael Kelly, the Four Masters goalie, giving it there to clubmate Mickey McBrearty to take the kick out. Bit of confusion there about the time. It's 24 and a half, 25 minutes gone in this first half, and Donegal 2 points down. Mickey McBrearty to take the kick. Up goes Anthony Malloy for it there. Anthony fists it on, but it only comes to a Derry man, and the Derry man is brought down, and it's a free. Derryman there being Dermot McNichol, their full forward, or their number 14. Again, a little bit of niggling there between Charlie Mulgrew and Derry midfielders. Terence McGuckie, and well-known place kicker from the Ballinderry club, to take this free kick for Derry. Inside the 50. It hasn't gone that far either, but it comes out to number 8, Eugene Murphy. Eugene Murphy still has the ball, but he can't get room. This time he gets it to Damian Barton. The ball is high, and this time it's well taken there. Well, was originally well taken, and the Donegal defence, I think it's Mickey McBrearty there being fouled, and once again the referee takes it out, giving Donegal a 14-yard advantage for either dissent or another foul after the original foul. Mickey McBrearty placing it. Mickey himself going to take it, this Thomond College student. Playing left back last Sunday, right back today. And this one is not particularly good, and it comes to the Derry forward line. And oh, and a lot of space out here for Terence McGuckie. And Terence McGuckie and taking the kick, but it's gone wide. And Derry too shooting their couple of wides in this first half. Michael Kelly placing the ball again. This time it looks, no, Mickey McBrady has gone in to take this one too. Mickey had come out seeing that the last time he did it, it left Terence McGuckie in free, and gave Derry a chance, which they didn't eventually take. 26 minutes gone. Out it comes, and it's Damian Barton blocking it down to Eugene Murphy. These two big Derry midfielders giving Donegal a lot of bother, and Eugene Murphy is fouled there by Brian Tuohy or by Matt Gallagher, one of the two of them, and it's a free for Derry, and Terence McGuckie is coming out to take this one. Number 8 and number 9 on the Derry team, Murphy and Barton, two very, very tall midfielders, leaving Donegal with a certain disadvantage there. Anthony Malloy, fine, big, tall fellow. Terence McGuckie to take the free. And this one is over the bar, and it's Derry's goal lead restored there after 27 minutes of the half. And it's Derry 1-2, Donegal 2 points. As I was saying there, Anthony Malloy is a fine, tall player, but Charlie Mulgrew lacking a bit in height there. And Donegal sometimes in bother at midfield. Mickey McBrearty to take the kick. Mickey takes it over again to the left-hand side, and it's coming down there. Charlie Mulgrew gets his foot in, but it's a free, and it's descent, and the free is taken 14 yard forwards by referee, forward by referee Michael. Taken quickly then by Derry to McNichol. McNichol being tackled there by Matt Gallagher. McNichol carrying. And it's another free-in for Derry. One of the reasons, I suppose, for so many frees is that referee Michael Cranny is applying the rules very strictly. And that foul by Matt Gallagher on McNichol as he went through gives another chance to Derry. to stretch their lead. Is wide, and again Donegal breathe a sigh of relief as Derry too are in the wide getting game. Michael Kelly placing the ball again for this kick out to be taken by Mickey McBrearty. Mickey's kick coming into the middle of the field there, and up goes Damien Barton and takes it very cleanly, and he's fouled, and it's a free for Derry once again. The last 4 or 5 minutes now, Derry have getting superiority there at midfield. Damien Barton leaves his kick now to Eugene Murphy, Derry's second midfielder. Eugene to take it. Dark clouds over St. Enda's field here in Oma. This free on the 50 by Eugene Murphy, and this one too dropping in the penalty area, and out comes Matt Gallagher. It's Mickey McBrearty. Mickey gives a terrible ball there to Eunan McIntyre. To be fair to Mickey, Eunan called for it. It comes across the goal to McNichol. McNichol, is he fouled? No, he's not. And out it comes there to Sian Boner. Sian Boner getting it out to Joyce McMullen. Joyce McMullen moving the ball well to Matt Gallagher. Anthony Malloy is free. And a great ball by Matt to Anthony. And Anthony now can do a bit of carrying. Pori Gallagher coming out to give him the room. Anthony's fouled. A free on the 50. Martin McHugh going over. Donegal trying to engineer something quickly there. And as we come into the last minute or minute and a half of this first half, Martin McHugh to take this free for Donegal, who are a goal down. Martin's kick this time is once again, always has the height. This time has the distance. A good point by Martin McHugh, and Donegal's third point, also Martin McHugh's third point. 1-2 to 3 points is the score as we come near half time. Donegal the 2 points down. The wind is coming across the field, blowing into our faces here in this chilly evening. And there goes a half-time whistle. So at half-time in this Ulster Under-21 football final, the score, as we see on the scoreboard there, is Derry 1-2, Donegal. Want to say something?
No. You're asking me. You're asking me. That's a mistake. Sure. Yeah.
Manon, camera now is Sean McGoldrick, one of the better known Donegal inter-county referees. And so for his comments on the first half, we'll ask Sean, does he fancy that Donegal can come back and win this game?
I think they can come back, no question about it, but this is a very team. And the height that you said earlier on there is a big disadvantage to Donegal. A lot of Donegal players who may be suffering hangovers from last weekend going to the celebrations down in Donegal Town and Ballyshannon. But they had a lot of play up there. Martin McHugh was definitely off his freeze there. I still think they can do it. There's not much in them, 2 points, 2 or 3 points. And it'll be very hard to beat now's Derry team.
Yeah, would you yourself make any changes in the Donegal team, positional or personnel, if you were out there instead of Tom Conaghan?
I don't think I would have changed the free taker there. Martin wasn't on the team. I would have given it to Joyce McMullen, same as Meehan. But Martin got a point there before the end, so it might bring back his confidence again, you know. I wouldn't make any changes. I don't think about any changes, no.
Thank you, Sean McGoldrick. And now we go back on for the beginning of the second half. I've been told at half time that St. Enda's Park here in Omagh, it was St. Enda's Park, but it's been called now the Michael Healy Memorial Park. Michael Healy, who spent so many years here as groundsman and as a main man here in Omagh's fine GA pitch. So the pitch has now been renamed after Michael Healy, so it's the Michael Healy Memorial Park. 1-2 to 3 points. Referee Michael Cranny of Down throws the ball in, and up they go, and it comes down on the Donegal side, but Charlie McGuru just blocking it down there, and it's a free for Derry. And again, a certain amount of niggling there, and a certain amount of retaliation, and the referee is throwing the ball in. Up goes Anthony Molloy with Eugene Murphy. The ball comes down, but again it breaks to a Derryman. Brian Chewy, good ball, Charlie Mulgrew. Charlie, the long left-footed ball in there. Out comes Pádraig Gallagher. The hop beats Pádraig. And Patrick McGroarty breaks it down. And it's a free in for Donegal. And so a chance for Donegal in the very first minute out of the second half. And one hopes now that Martin McHugh, the Kilcar wizard, can get his shooting boots in the second half and get this one over the bar. But he doesn't, and it's well taken there on the goal line, and out it comes, and up goes one of the Donegal midfielders on the back of a Derry man, and it's a free for Derry again. On the ground there is Eugene Murphy. Eugene appears to be taking the kick himself, tying the lace there, leaving it then for James McGuckian, the McGuckians of Ballinderry, one of the famous footballing families in County Derry. James taking this kick now. Up goes Eunan McIntyre. Eunan is fouled. Eunan held back there by Kieran Quinn. Kieran protests. Referee says leave it down, and it's a free for Donegal. Brian Chewy trying to take a quick one, doesn't manage it. Brian now settling it down. Donegal team, of course, not used to this kind of pitch, the size of this pitch, and you find that good movements continue to about the 50, which would normally be the goal line in Donegal. High fielding there by McNabb. McNabb getting it across this side. Donegal man coming out there is Matt Gallagher. Matt Gallagher robs McNichol. Matt still has the ball. Does he get it? He does. He gets it into Shamey Meehan. Shamey Meehan now on his left foot. Shamey gets the ball in. It looks a good one there. It's curling in. In comes Donegal forward, but the ball goes wide. Paddy McGroarty rushing in there, but he couldn't make it. So it's another wide ball for Donegal. And certainly, if this game goes against them eventually, it'll be their own shooting, their own wides that will be largely to blame. 3 minutes of the second half, John Mackell to take the kick out now for Derry. John's kick coming into the middle of the field. Up goes Charlie Mulgrew. Charlie Mulgrew, Damien Barton. Damien Barton fouled by Charlie Mulgrew. Another free. Donegal in trouble periodically there. And up goes another Derry forward. Ball breaks loose there to Charlie Mulgrew. Charlie Mulgrew trying to get out. He's still on the ball. Charlie still has it. Charlie holds it too long and gives away a free. And it's not a particularly happy time for Donegal at the moment. Down in front of us there we see that Bundoran centre halfback Donal Reid warming up. Donal had a very good championship campaign with Bundoran and maybe coming into the game soon. Advantage allowed there by the referee. Ball comes to Kieran Devlin. Kieran, free shot at goal there. Gets it into the full forward. Coming, he still has it. Tries to get it out. Gets it out again to Kieran Devlin. Kieran Devlin now has another chance, and this one goes in and is well taken there on the chest by Mickey McBerty. Out nicely to Tommy McDermott. The long ball again there with Paddy McGroarty having to run 60 yards for it. And Paddy still fighting for it. Kieran Devlin gets it. Still has it. Gets it inside there to Brian Chewy. Brian Chewy coming out, but Brian Chewy goes into the back of one of the Derry men, and it's a free kick for Derry. James McGuckian to take this free for Derry. The refereeing is very strict, but very consistent and very fair. McGuckian's free, going away in there. Up they go, 5-6 men, blocked down by a Donegal man to a Derry man. It's McNichol. McNichol causing a fair bit of problem there. He takes the shot, and it's over the bar. A point for Derry. McNichol, 1-3 to 3 points. After 5 minutes of the second half. Mickey McBerty to take the kick out. And now the substitution is being made. Donal Reid is going into the Donegal team, number 17, the Crossroads man, former Red Hughes player, now playing with Bundoran, and Patrick McGroarty from St. Noel's coming out here, one of the corner forwards. Now there'll be switches, obviously, in the Donegal team following this. It looks as if Donal Reid is going into midfield and Anthony Molloy into full forward, and Joyce McMullen fielding that ball brilliantly and giving it to Charlie Mulgrew. And surely the ball placed for it now is to Anthony Molloy. It's Donal Reid, first touch, short ball, Shamey Meehan. Shamey turning around. A high ball now going in, but it's not a really scoring shot. Blocked down, and across comes one of the Derry defenders. Donegal forward still has it, gets it out there. And once again, it's a blazing wide for Donegal. So after 6 minutes of the second half, John Mackell taking the kick. Anthony Molloy is now in at full forward. Donal Reid at midfield. Coming out towards Joyce McMullen, and Joyce goes high. And once again, Joyce doing very well there. Ball comes to Porrick Gallagher. Porrick Gallagher giving the ball out. Now the long one inside to Donal Reid. Donal in the game again. Good ball to Molloy. Molloy in a run. Can he get the shot? It's wide. And the referee is given the free for the late tackle. Anthony Molloy fouled as he shot there. And so a chance for Donegal to get back to within 2 points of Derry. Donal Reid having a significant impact on the game in the one or 2 minutes that he's been on the field. Involved in both movements there. Anthony Molloy going through but couldn't finish it off. But gets the free. Joyce is taking this one. Joyce McMullen from the Four Masters Club. Joyce sends it over the bar, and it's another point for Donegal. 1-3 to 4 points. 7 minutes of the second half gone. Donegal again within 2 points of Derry. Joyce McMullen seems to be moving into the middle of the field now. Shamie Meehan is going left half forward. Charlie Mulgrew is going centre half forward. Porrick Gallagher is going top of the left. And so the whole Donegal forward line is revamped now. Up goes Shamie Meehan. Shamie Meehan is on the back of Liam Quinn, Liam Devlin, the Derry right half. Certain amount of confusion here on my part. The right half actually is Liam Devlin. He's being called Kieran Quinn and Kieran Devlin, but he's actually Liam Devlin, the fair-haired lad. They're playing well. High, and up goes Brian Chewy for it. Brian breaks it down. Tommy McDermott's boot goes in high there, but the referee lets it go. Eunan McIntyre fumbles a bit, but comes through now. He's being tackled by three Derry men. Gets the ball away over now to Martin McHugh. Could we get Martin going now? Martin going now with his Derry marker with him. He sends the ball down to Paul Carr. Paul, a quiet game, pushed in the back, free for Donegal. Joyce McMullen going to take this free for Donegal after 8 minutes of the second half. 2 points between the teams. Donegal brightening up there in the last few minutes with the change. Long kick by Joyce. Up goes Shamie Meehan. Blocks it down, but only to a Derryman. But now it comes to Donegalman. Martin McHugh. Martin getting the ball inside. Coming through again to Paul Carr. Paul fails to get it. And it's the Derry left halfback Paul McAllister over there. Another Derryman trying to get out. Fouled as he comes out. Free. We can see from the tricolour in front of us there that the wind is slightly in favour of Donegal now. Still a crossish wind. Out comes this ball into the middle of the field. Matt Gallagher there. Matt punches it down. It comes back again. And back again. And Donegal now getting more of this. And out it comes to Anthony Molloy. Anthony's added height in there. Going to have a difference. Good ball inside of Chewy. Can Chewy get it going? Chewy's fouled. It's a free and it's pointable. Good football there by Donegal. This time it's Joyce McMullen coming across to take the free. And certainly if the Donegal place kicking was up to the usual Martin McHugh standard, we would have been ahead at the moment. But things are looking up now, and it's Joyce McMullen going to take this one. And again it's gone wide. Another wasted chance by Donegal after 10 minutes of the second half, and they remain 2 points behind. John Mackell placing the ball for the kick out. Donegal now completely on top territorially for the last 5 minutes. They're still 2 points behind. John Mackell. Up goes Donal Reid. Donal blocks it down, but only to a Derry man. And now the danger here of the Derry breakaway. Tommy McDermott. The ball breaks down to number 10. He's carrying in there the long left-footed shots. Up goes Mickey McBurty. Mickey takes it very, very well and gets rid of it beautifully there. Great football. Eunan McIntyre. Eunan still carrying. Eunan, the long ball inside there now. to Charlie Mulgrew. Charlie carrying. Charlie still carrying. Charlie now the long high ball. Inside to Porrick Gallagher. Paul Carr breaks down to a Derry defender. Picks it off the ground and it's another chance for Donegal. Charlie Mulgrew lining up to take this one. But no, it's back again to Martin McHugh. Straight in accurate and over the bar. And now there's only 1 point between the teams after 11 minutes of the second half. 1-3 for Derry, 5 points for Donegal. That point from Martin McHugh from a free. Most of Donegal's points are from frees. And hopefully now that leaves them settled. They're only a point behind. They're very much in the game. John Mackell to take the kick out. Our number five here, Liam Devlin, standing on his own. Up goes Martin McHugh. And Martin now, more like the old Martin we know, getting the ball to Shamey Meehan. Shamey Meehan, good ball inside to Anthony Malloy. And big Anthony from Ardara. Hopping the ball, getting it out there to Martin. Martin making the room, still going. Now on his left, sending the ball across, a little difficult there, Brock down, and a shot, and it comes through, a chance for Pori Gallagher, the equaliser! And the Ballantraman taking that point well, and Donegal are level after 12 minutes of the second half. Pori Gallagher, the point scorer there, as he drew on the ball, and it went over the bar, 1-3 to 6. And the Ballantra contingent here beside is happy now as Porrick leaves his mark on the game. Now hopefully Donegal can keep this up. Mackell's kick out. Coming out on this side. Charlie Mulgrew going up and Charlie breaks it down to Porrick Gallagher. Porrick Gallagher inside to Charlie Mulgrew. Charlie going through. Charlie soloing in. Can he get it? He goes on his own. Sends it inside there to Shamey. Shamey! Or am I? Shamey Meehan the scorer. From a fine move by Charlie Mulgrew. Great Donegal point there, as Donegal now are moving in something like top gear. Two fine points there. 13 minutes of the second half gone. Here comes the kick out. Up goes Donald Reid, and Donald breaks it down. Martin McHugh going down on it, Derry men there too. Everybody fighting for it. Donegal ball. And so the tide is swinging Donegal's way at the moment. Eunan McIntyre taking the kick intelligently to Martin McHugh. Martin with lots of space here. Can Martin make it? He takes the shot. Wide. And so now Donegal, if they can turn the superiority into scores, will have a good chance. Paddy Keeney here having trouble with the Ballantra banners. And the ball is behind the Ballantra banner and a Derryman is coming out with it. And in it comes here now to Brian Chewy. And Brian going up and this is good. Brian, kick block down. Coming to Matt. Matt to Eunan. Eunan McIntyre from St. Eunan's. The ball out to Martin McHugh. Martin McHugh and Paul McAllister. But Martin is now going better. He's got Donald Reid inside him. He's still on the ball. Still on the ball. The long ball inside now to number 8. Malloy and he's fouled and it's a free for Donegal. And if this pattern continues, there'll be a lot of praise for Donegal's changes. The presence of Anthony Malloy in the edge of the square has changed things there. Donald Reid has improved things at midfield. They're playing with a renewed confidence now after 14 minutes of the second half. And will this confidence continue as Martin is going to take this free? Martin McHugh from Kilcar, Donegal's Player of the Year 1981. One of the country's leading scorers. And that's more like the left foot of Martin that we know. And it's 2 points ahead. 8 points to 1-3. Good point by Martin McHugh there to send Donegal further into the lead by 2 points. And now things are looking far happier for the Donegal team at the moment here. Out comes the kick into the middle of the field. And it's Brian Chewy playing like a man inspired at the moment. The ball to McHugh. McHugh, eye off, eye on, inside. Grand ball, another beautiful ball to Reid. Donal Reid coming through. And the ball is moved away there. Comes across to Shamey Meehan. Shamey Meehan to Martin McHugh. And Martin, as if to answer critics coming into this game, so alive and so full of running now and being one of the major changes. The kick out is very quick there, and Derrier coming away and is spotted by Anthony Molloy, but the ball comes out into the middle. Up goes Matt Gallagher. Matt takes it clear, but it loses it then. Out it comes now to Eunan McIntyre. Eunan trying to get down, and another free for Donegal. And the referee takes it forward 14 yards for dissent by Derry's number 12, Kieran Quinn, but there is more dissent, and now the referee is going to talk to him. Donegal going well now, but must be conscious of the fact that they're just the 2 points ahead. Matt Gallagher to take this kick. Matt from Ballantra. The high one into Molloy from Ardara, and Molloy from Ardara scoops it out of the sky. Beautiful ball inside, but the keeper comes out. And the keeper is fouled there, and it's a free out. It's a free in. The referee says it was a foul hand pass. And it's a free in for Donegal. The first hand pass incident of the game there, and it was a goalkeeper is coming out, and he hand passed the ball illegally. And now it's another chance for Martin McHugh to put Donegal a clear goal clear. Straight Pat Ackerett and over the bar. And Martin McHugh stretches it now to a goal. 9 points to 1-3. And the second half, it's just 1 team in it. And that's Donegal. Derry making a substitution at the moment. There are 17 minutes gone in the second half. There's still 13 to go. But as things are going at the moment, they're going beautifully for Donegal. High fielding there by the Derry left half forward, Kieran Quinn. Kieran Quinn being hassled there, gets the ball inside. And Matt breaks it down to Joyce. And Joyce sends a good ball up here to Pádraig Gallagher. Pádraig from Ballantra, using a bit of the Finn Harps touch there. Shamey Meehan getting the ball inside. The goalkeeper's coming out, the left back, but the left back Convery getting it there, coming out with it, gets it out, fouled after. But Derry have possession, and it's McNichol. McNichol fouled there by Charlie Mulgrew, free for Derry. Things going so well for Donegal at the moment. The free is taken in the wrong place. The referee calls him back, and it's to be taken again. Derry simply not in this game for the last quarter of an hour, but Donegal must learn to keep their concentration and not let this one slip, because it looks like an Ulster title, the second of this year. The Miners haven't won the Minor League. And Matt Gallagher is going up this time. No, he leaves it, and it's a Derry man, Damien Barton. Damien Barton fouled. Takes the quick free there. Sean Boner is obviously fouled there, and it's a free out. Right. The referee sending Mickey McBrady back. Mickey must have heard some Derry dissent that the referee didn't there, and he was taking it out the 14. And he takes a quick, intelligent free to Brian Chewy. Brian Chewy having a great second half. An awkward ball, but it's the Ballyshannon man to the Bundoran man. And up comes Donal Reid to Shamey Meehan, but it's a difficult ball. And it's McGuckian, but across there again with great determination comes Anthony Molloy. And a Derry defender coming out, trying to burst his way out. He's fouled by the Donegal man. Pádraig Gallagher getting involved unnecessarily there, one would feel. And it's a free out. They're nearly 20 minutes gone in the second half. And it goes into the middle of the field. And up it comes down again on the Donegal side, as everything seems to. Joyce McMullen. Joyce. Can Joyce get the kick in? Joyce gets a high one in there, and again it's Molloy, and Molloy takes it clear. And the kick, as very often with Anthony, is that little bit wide. But Anthony Molloy's inspired catching in there has been a definite effect in this game. Donegal 9 points to 1-3. Things going so well for Donegal in the second half. And I see Tom Conaghan down there on the sideline, with his second big victory on the cards within a week. Up they go. This one breaks through to Meehan, but it's a Derry man getting it away. Free for Derry. A lot of blowing in this game. But referee Cranny very much on top of things and very satisfactory. Sylvester Maguire running along the sideline here. He might be in the game yet again another. This time it's Devlin. Devlin, one of Derry's good players. Devlin getting the ball inside to Terence McGuckian. McGuckian getting around there. Gets the high ball in and a good and an accurate and a point for Derry. It's 9 points to 1-4. 21 minutes gone. Sylvester Maguire is in the game. And Donegal must not let this slip. The Ulster title is there for the taking, but it's only 2 points in it. Sylvester Maguire is in the game. It's not as yet obvious who's coming off. It may be Paul Carr. The referee saying, hold on. It is Paul Carr. Paul having a quiet kind of a game over there on the right wing. Out comes a kick. And up goes Quigg, the Derry substitution. Quigg on the ball. Quigg still going through. Still going through. Tommy McDermott meets him well. Comes loose there to McElhinney. McElhinney out to McGuckian. McGuckian coming in there. McGuckian still. And it's over the bar. 1-6 to 8 points. Two fine points there by Derry. And the game has suddenly swung again. 22 gone. 9 to go. Derry hitting back there with good style. And fine points by Terence McGuckian. Getting away twice there from the marking. Mickey McBrady to take the kick out. Into the middle of the field. Up goes Joyce McMullen. And again it's a Derry man coming through. James McGuckian. James McGuckian. And now the tide is turning again. Great ebb and flow in this game. James McGuckian fouled there. Leaving the free to one of his midfield men. High ball, again a dangerous ball, and is well fielded in there by one of the Donegal defenders. It's Joyce McMullen. Joyce is held, and Joyce playing so well. McIntyre, Union to Martin McHugh in space now. Can Martin sell the dummy and get away? He gets it away down to Anthony Molloy. Anthony Molloy, out now at midfield. The long left-footed ball, can it be added on by Porrick? He breaks it down, but it comes out to a Derry man. And this is a fine game of football now as the ball comes up again to the Derry forward line. Swings across the side. Matt Gallagher going there with McNichol. But it's another Derry man who's on the ball. And it's McElhinney. McElhinney. Good ball into the space. Sean Boner. Sean Boner held there or fouled there. And it was a lucky thing because it broke well for Derry. And referee Cranny spotted it. And Donegal hearts rest. 24 minutes gone. And out comes the ball into the middle of the field. And another Derryman there, Damien Barton. Damien Barton to McGuckian. And McGuckian's kicking now, really giving Donegal problems. Quigg is waiting for the ball here. The other man is on it. Gets it out to Quigg. Quigg moving inside. There's another substitution that has a decided impact. Takes a shot and it's gone wide. Fortunately for Donegal. And so it's 9 points to 1-5. With 6 minutes left, Matt Gallagher in no hurry to take this kick out. Matt Gallagher with the kick. Into the middle of the field. Up they go. Shamie Meehan going up, but again it comes down for it to a Derry man. Terence McGuckian, and Terence McGuckian certainly will be Derry's saviour if Derry come back into this game. Ball lost there, and go again from Terence McGuckian. Sean Boner breaks it. Eunan McIntyre, the ball is on the ground. Nobody gets it up. Out it comes, and it comes across there to Sylvester Maguire of Irua Ballyshannon. Can Sylvester get it up the field to Martin McHugh? And the Kilcarman man now on a solo, being chased by Damien Barton. The ball has gone over the line, and fortunately it's a Donegal line ball. Another sub gone on for the Derry team. Martin McHugh to take the kick. It's on the 50-yard line. The linesman there placing it more accurately. Five minutes left in this game. Martin McHugh with a 52-yard sideline kick. And how sweet of this went over the bar. It doesn't, it's shorter. And who goes up for it? It's Joyce McDonnell-Reed, but it comes out. And it's Derry moving away. Chance for Donegal to pick it up again. It's picked up there by Charlie Mulgrew. Can Charlie get through the gap? He loses the ball. He fights to regain it. He's fouled and it's a free. The new Derry substitute there is Paul Dugan, according to my informant Sean McGoldrick. Charlie Mulgrew there. A little bit fortunate to get that free, but it's an important free for Donegal. Pádraig Gallagher standing there, Martin McHugh standing there, giving the responsibility to Martin. 4 minutes of this game left. Donegal 1 point ahead. Martin McHugh having a free from about 40 yards. And how sweet of this free gave Donegal the lead. The referee talking to Martin, and I think, and he's adding on the time. Martin trying to make sure that this one anyway goes over. As is all of Donegal's good support here. Yes, it's over the bar! A fine point by Martin McHugh. And so, with only about 5 minutes of the game left, Donegal are two ahead, 10 points to 1-2. Up goes, Shamie Meehan can't get up to it. Damien Barton on the ball, Damien still has it. Damien gets it way down now. Eunan McIntyre, Tommy McDermott there. Eunan going up again. Breaks down to Eunan, and well done Eunan. And Eunan fouled, and well done the man from Letterkenny, Eunan McIntyre there for Donegal. Matt Gallagher placing the ball. Another substitute on the Derry team. 4 minutes left. Matt Gallagher from Ballintra. 10 to 1-5. Matt's kick, long. Charlie Mulgrew going up, but is well taken by Devlin for Derry. Charlie fouls him, and so Derry get it again. Eugene Murphy leaving it there to McNabb, right back McNabb. This tough, competitive game. McNabb's kick is high. Donald Reid, can he? Yes, he drops it down there, and it's cleared out, and it's coming out on this side. Come on, Pádraig Gallagher. Pádraig won't reach this one. It's a line ball for Derry. Brian McAuleen is in the game for Derry now, another well-known Derry footballing family. Star of Donegal Derry minor teams the past few years. This line ball coming in now. Up they go. And it's well taken by Derry's Andy Quigg, who's had a big influence in this game. And Joyce again back there, and another free for Donegal. The refereeing very, very sharp here. And so with 3 minutes or so, the ball coming down. Martin Sylvester Maguire pushes, and you don't get away with much in this game. Derry coming forward again. She's high, and it breaks down. Gallagher going back there. Will he get down on it? And the Ballintra man does. And Matt, a long clearance now out to Martin, and Martin breaks it down, but he can't hold it. Derry man, did he touch it on the ground? No, he still has it. Derry send the ball in now, and Brian Toohey breaks it down. Great determination by Brian to get that one. Another Derry man on it. The high kick inside. This one goes wide, and the palpitation of Donegal hearts goes easier again as Michael Kelly sees it go wide. 1 minute. 1 minute of the game left. The short free to kick out to Mickey McBrearty. Can Mickey get round it? He does. Intelligent play by Donegal. To Eunan, and McKee's with him, and a 50-50 ball and a foul, and that's a very important one as Donegal will get possession and move up. And so Donegal on the verge, on the edge of an Ulster title now. This fine, talented under 21 team beaten in the final last year by Monaghan, coming back, and now in the Michael Healy Park, Omagh, looks as if they're going to take the Ulster under 21 football championship back across Lifford Bridge. They have! Donegal have won the Ulster under 21 title with a fine second half display, and great joy there for the Donegal team, and how well they deserve it, having beaten Cavan, having beaten Down, having come here now to beat Derry after an raised up there. And what a great and hopeful occasion this is for Donegal football. This team now should certainly go ahead and come back to win great honours and hopefully one day lift the Anglo-Celt Cup and take it back to Donegal, the Ulster Sea.
Well, our son, Coyola, White Lumsa, Cogargis, Horchta, Furin, Bua, Shock, Anocht, Agusta Sulagam, Gomeh Tleha, An White, Aku, and Sulak, Janis Naharan. I'd also like to congratulate Derry and as well as Donegal on the fine display shown here tonight. And it's, I think, one of the best football teams at county level, one of the best football games at county level that I've seen in Ulster this year. So, Brian, congratulations. Congratulations to Donegal, and I hope they do very well with the Lions.
This celebration is here in the Donegal camp here in Victory.
Just listen.
Your action to the game, Tom.
Well, first of all, ladies and gentlemen, this is a great moment for Donegal. And there's one thing about this team. From the day I took them over, they never let me down. And there's only...
I don't know what to say. I'm just delighted that we've won it after last year's disappointment. And I can't thank our great supporters enough. They were brilliant. And I'm sure they had a big part to play in our great victory here today. And I just hope that we can go on there and win this All-Ireland, because I think we're capable of it. And I'd like to thank Derry for a great team performance. And I'd like to give them 3 cheers. Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! No, I would like to give special thanks to Tom Conaghan, and I would also like 3 cheers for Tom Conaghan and his team mentors, Michael Lafferty and Donal Monaghan. Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! Thank you very much.
Led by Brian Chewy. And the great Donegal ovation here in Sean McDermott Park. It seems that all of Donegal has gathered on the stand opposite us here for the All-Ireland Under-21 final. The Donegal team now settling down for the photograph on this wonderfully historic day in the annals of the GAA in the county. The panel now lining up there with the camera focusing in on them. Roscommon on our right. Conditions here in Sean McDermott Park are not good. There is a wind blowing from the left towards the right as we look across at the stand and the lots and lots and thousands of Donegal supporters who have come to this occasion. Referee Tommy Moran making his way out now as the Donegal team faces the camera. Some late selection doubts about the Donegal team, which we'll see about in a moment. And so Donegal now move off to the left on this first real All-Ireland final for Donegal. And the men from Donegal in their green there. On the other side, the Roscommon team in the traditional, famous gold and blue of Roscommon. A marvellous occasion here in Park Sean McDiarmid as Donegal have really come.
Today we welcome to Park Sean McDiarmid, our county chairman, Donegal, the champions of Ulster.
Most of the Donegal following on the far side.
Donegal, referee today, Eastern County Secretary Tommy Bourne. And his umpires, Charlie McCormick, Dan Galopi, Sean Sullivan, and Andy Rannis, all from Ballinamore. The linesmen today, Peter Cox from Anaduff, and Shane Ellis from Barnacoola.
The Roscommon team leaning out now for their team photograph. The Roscommon team who caused a sensation by beating Cork in the All-Ireland semi-final. Donegal team manager. And so the game is about to begin. Creave na hair and fui fi is a hain. Tommy Moran throws it in and we're away, and Anthony Malloy goes up. Donald Reid, Charlie Mulgrew, Charlie along the ground. Shamie Meehan slips, cleared out there by one of the Roscommon players. Anthony Malloy coming through. McNeil from Roscommon getting it there. No, it's a midfielder now, Glancy. Glancy, long ball up, and it's Tommy. Tommy McDermott into the corner to Shamie Meehan. Shamie Meehan on the ball. He's got help from Donal Reid. Donal's coming through. He gives it there, but it's taken away by Gary Wynn. Gary Wynn tackled. And he's well hustled there by Paul Carr. Paul Carr still struggling for the ball there, and it's a 50 for Donegal. Good, gritty start by Donegal. Joyce McMullen handing the ball to the linesman. The linesman says, place it yourself. And so Joyce McMullen, given the first chance here, but is a strongish wind blowing against Joyce as he takes this kick. Right-footed, slips out towards Patrick McGroarty. Patrick takes it on the chest, takes it well. Gets it back there to Martin McHugh. Martin's shot, high. And Ackered, it's a point for Donegal. Martin McHugh, the scorer. A magnificent start for Donegal. Great fielding by Patrick McGroarty. Fine pass to Martin McHugh. And Martin from Kilcar starting us off in great style with that point. Marvellously taken point, the beginning of this game to settle us down. The kick out to be taken by G.P. Cuniff, the Roscommon goalie. Out it comes, middle of the field. Glancy going up, comes down. Kicked away over to the far side. Roscommon now on the attack, in it goes to full forward, Early. Early, who's Roscommon's most famous player. Still Early, tackled by Tommy McDermott. Still tackled by Tommy. Paul Early still on it. Paul gets it in low. Dangerous ball, and in it goes, and Mickey McBrearty is covering. Oh, Mickey fumbles it, and Mickey picks it off the ground. A 14-yard free. Early nerves there on right back Mickey McBrearty, and so a chance for Roscommon to equalise. Jimmy Conlon over the bar for the equaliser. And so Donegal find themselves level after 3 minutes of the game. The kick out is to be taken by Mickey McBrearty. Donald Reid going for it. Comes there to the Roscommon midfielder. Shoved away there by Tommy McDermott. Anthony Malloy on the ball. Anthony is held there. Anthony still has the ball. Gets it away here to Charlie Mulgrew going up for it. McNeil breaks it down. Charlie gets it inside. Another Roscommon coming out. Free for Roscommon. Shoves away Charlie Mulgrew there. Free up by Charlie on Manus Tierney. Charlie not happy. In it goes, and the Roscommon tactic of hitting Paul Early, very obvious early on. Paul Hickey going out for this ball now, tackled by Mickey McBrearty. Mickey still holding on to him. Mickey, it's got away there, and it's McHugh. Martin on the ball. Martin gets it overhead to Donal Reid. Donal, tackled there. getting his foot in there and then scrambled out, and it's Donal Reid again. Ball coming to Russ Cummins, Tiernan. Tiernan the ball in again. Sean Boner. Sean slips and gets the ball away, where Eunan McIntyre is going up for it with one of the Roscommon players. Roscommon to them. Comes inside to one of the attacking halfbacks, Marty Shanahan, and Shanahan takes the point. Some uncertainty in the Donegal full back line in the first couple of minutes. 5 minutes of the game gone. 2 points for Roscommon, one from Donegal. That one coming from Marty Shanahan, who's going up. I think. Out comes that kick, a better kick. Up they go. Comes down again to Roscommon. Joyce going in. Roscommon man still has it. Gets the ball in. And once again, the ball is hit too early. Early, this time shoved off by Sean Boner. Coming through to Conlon. Conlon still going. And one of the Donegal defenders there. Again, another chance for Roscommon. The ball goes in again too early. Too much for early this time. And it's gone wide to Donegal's relief. And so a pattern emerging early on of this very much used tactic in GAA modern times of hitting your full forward if he's big and strong and talented like Paul Early is, so reminiscent of his brother Dermot. This kick again taken by Mickey McBrady. No, by Matt Gallagher that was. Up goes Anthony Malloy, breaks it down. But again it's Rogers. Rogers. Eamon McManus it is. Eamon McManus with Tommy McDermott. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 steps. Yes, Tommy Moran blows him up. Referees having recent instructions to make it 4 steps and putting into a force there. That rule was Tommy Moran. Porrig Gallagher already seen running along the sideline there. As early Donegal nerves in the full back line giving a cause to worry. Mickey McBrady misses the kick. Tommy McDermott doing a lot of covering today. Gets the ball up there to Patrick McGroarty. Patrick McGroarty fails to get it. And it's Gary Wynn. We can see that Patrick McGroarty is playing away over there on the right rather than in his chosen position of left corner forward, with Shamie Meehan moving more to the left. Martin McHugh, 52 yards out against a wind and a very strong rainy breeze coming across there now. Meehan going up for it. Can he get it? No. Comes across to Paul Carr. Paul, is Paul brought down? No. Referee says no, and it's a goal kick for Roscommon. 6 minutes of the game gone, and it seems that Donegal are going to make a substitution already. I see Mickey Lafferty down there writing in a substitute note, and with Porrig Gallagher running up and down the sideline, it would seem that Donegal are taking very early action. Whether it's something to do with Sean Boner's injury and the obvious ploy of playing Paul Early remains to be seen. Up they go, and it's Charlie Mulgrew going in there. Charlie hasn't got it yet, but Patrick McGroarty is fighting, and Pat fighting, and it's coming out to the Roscommon left back there, Gay Collins. Gay Collins upfield, and well taken by Tommy McDermott. And Tommy, certainly Donegal's best player so far, getting it through to Anthony Malloy. Anthony Malloy from Ardara, short ball to Shamie Meehan. Shamie going for the middle. A lovely ball inside there. And there must be a free for Donegal. No, the referee allows play on. Donal Reid. Reid shot and a point. Grand football by Donegal there, and a fine point by Donal Reid. Good, patient, controlled football. And substitute Donal Reid immediately making an impact on the game. It seems, yes, Donegal are already making a substitution. Porrig Gallagher from Ballintra is coming into the game. A very, very early Donegal substitution here. Now the question is it the jitters and the full back line that is causing it? Seems to be. Porrig, number 13 in, after 8 minutes of the game, gives it to Tommy Moran. He's going forward. Yes, it's a big long switch, and it seems a bit harsh on Seamus Meehan that he's coming off this early, but it's... Or is he? Sean Boner has come off. Sean Boner is off because of the injury, and their wholesale switches. Tommy McDermott going back. Donal Reid centre half. Joyce midfield. Joyce trying to get to that one. Brian Chewy going for it now. High tackle by Brian. He will be spoken to perhaps by referee Tommy Moran. And so Donegal, with Sean Boner's injury giving him early start, and a very, very disappointed Sean Boner, naturally after a long campaign And here he is after 8 minutes of the game, taken off. And this ball has gone wide. Sean Bonner, doubtful all weekend because of an injury, but Sean now seems really distraught and really disappointed. Being talked to now by Tom Cunahan down under us as this kick out is about to be taken. A very difficult decision. There, up goes Anthony Molloy for this one. And Anthony brings it down, but is it to a Donegalman? It's to himself. And it's Anthony coming out through them there. And still Anthony. And Anthony, the long ball to Charlie Mulgrew. But Charlie won't make that one. Charlie not happy with the service. And so it's a line ball for Roscommon. We see in under us here, behind the gate there, Sean Bonner. And the kick, Brian Chewy going up, breaking it down to Patrick McGroarty. Patrick McGroarty playing well today. Patrick carrying this ball now. Tackle there, gets the ball, misses the kick, and it's number 10 for Roscommon. Corcoran getting the ball in again to Early. Early this time marked by McDermott. Eunan McIntyre comes across and takes it very well. And he's held there by a few Roscommon men. And Eunan comes through them. And Eunan sends a ball up to Shimmy Meehan, where Shimmy should be. Brian Chewy missing it there. And Roscommon back on the attack again. Corcoran, the man. Jersey pull there, gets the ball in. Well taken one-handed there by Brian Chewy. Matt Gallagher from Ballintra. This side of the field in for a lane ball for Roscommon. So the Donegal reshuffling brings Tommy McDermott back on Paul Early, brings Donal Reid into his natural position of centre-half, brings Joyce McMullen into his beginning position of midfield. Glancy's kick going in again for Early. It's as regular as rain. Brian Chewy. Matt outside him there. Brian gets it in now to the middle, but it's a Roscommon man there again, and he takes it well. Getting it across and making life difficult again here for Glancy for Roscommon. It's a Roscommon lane ball. Eamon Glancy. Once again, the hit for Hurley. Up they go, and it's well taken by Mickey McBrearty. Mickey settling down now after that early slip, getting the ball out towards Joyce McMullen. Joyce getting it up there, followed by Eamon Glancy. Joyce beats the tackle, sends it to Anthony Molloy. Anthony and Rogers. Anthony finding difficulty there. Still fighting for it. Ball breaks to Matt Gallagher. Matt, good ball. Well seen. Charlie Mulgrew. Charlie, shoulder there by McNeil. Good old-fashioned shoulder. Fouled then by McNeil. Charlie leaves it down. Takes the short quickly to Joyce. Joyce now. The long ball to the empty space. Paul Carr running for it. Paul, good hefty shoulder tackle there. Breaks loose. And it's McNeil again back covering well for Roscommon. It's Marty Shanahan. And it's a free kick for Donegal. Referee Tommy Moran very much up with play there, very clear signals all the time, very much in control of this game. Now this free is inside the 50, and it's Martin McHugh having a shot, but again with the conditions it would be difficult to expect Martin to point this one. He fails to bring her in early enough, and it's gone wide. He had the distance that time, but the direction was a bit off. She curled in, but it was late, so it's goalkeeper Cuniff to take it out for Roscommon. 12 minutes of the game gone. Very even game. Donegal must be quite satisfied with their performance so far. 2 points each, with Roscommon having the advantage of wind and the sleety rain that the wind is blowing down the field. Cuniff's kick out coming in here to the middle of the field, where it's brought down by a Roscommon man. But it's Glancy touching it on the ground, gets away with it. Patrick McGroarty of St. Noel's. Patrick, his kick is blocked down there. Right half-back, Marty Shanahan. Shanahan getting the ball downfield now to Brian Chewy. Brian goes up but fails to bring it down cleanly. But out comes Matt Gallagher, and that's typical Matt. And Matt gets it along the ground to Joyce. Joyce, man inside, good ball, well seen. Charlie Mulgrew. Charlie shouldered again by McNeil. Charlie cutting inside. Ball into Shamey Meehan. Shamey fails to hold. And out comes her on fullback, getting the ball out to her. Anthony Molloy. Is that Anthony? Nearly takes it on the chest, just fails. Down it goes to Tommy. Tommy getting it away there from Paul Early. Tommy doing a good job on Paul Early, getting the ball to Donal Reid. Donal coming up the field now with the ball to Chewy. Brian looking around. The ball in again to Patrick McGroarty. McGroarty going through. Still going. Oh, bad bounce. Gives it inside. Paul Carr fails, and the bounce was just unfortunate there for Donegal. Shamey Meehan. Meehan across the goal. Chance. Must be. Over the bar. Pádraig Gallagher. Oh, And so Pádraig Gallagher justifying his being brought onto the field with a fine point there. And Patrick McGroarty, who's playing so well, just unlucky that his toe-to hand went too much toe. Up goes Anthony, and Anthony hits it down to an inspired Martin McHugh. In there now to Joyce. Joyce cutting through them, followed by McNeil. Joyce still going. Lovely ball. Pádraig, great save. Joyce. The referee blows, it's a Donegal ball, and that should have been a Donegal goal. It was a great ball, a great chance for Pádraig Gallagher, but fair play to keeper Cunniff, he did magnificently well. And so it's 3-2 after a quarter of an hour, and Donegal tremendously happy so far with this performance. Malloy marvellous at midfield, moving sweetly. And two goal chances that hopefully they will not rue later on. But they certainly have the beating of this Roscommon team. In goes the short ball. Paul Carr not having a happy day in there so far. Out comes Roscommon man. He's fouled by Paul Carr, and it's a free out for Roscommon. And so Donegal with two great chances there as the game settles down again. 3-2. In she comes, and Anthony will go again, and it breaks down to Donal Reid. Donal Reid playing a great game, sending the ball away out to Shamey Meehan. Shamey. The ball to Martin McHugh, and they're cutting threads through this Roscommon defence. Martin being held. Martin taking a shot, and it's over the bar. And the Donegal crowd really urging their team on. The Donegal crowd urging them on. Patrick McGroarty is in a bit of bother there as he comes out. But McHugh's on song. Out comes the kick out. And it's Joyce going up with Glancy hitting it down. This time it's the Roscommon men. And once again the high Roscommon ball in to get early. And Tommy, Donal Reid covering up. Donal doing very well. And a beautiful ball out to Brian Chewy. No, just a little bit too long, and it's a Roscommon ball. Jimmy Conlon. Or Connellan. Again, the high ball into the square. And it goes all the way, and it's gone wide, and it's 4-2 for Donegal. 17 minutes gone, and this is a marvellous Donegal performance so far. Matt Gallagher taking this kick out, the Ballantra man. And Anthony again is coming for it, and Anthony breaks it down, but it comes to the Roscommon man on the break. But Donegal are fighting for every ball there. McGroarty again. The high ball goes in from Paul Hickey. Up they go, but Donegal seem to be winning everything so far. Matt out there to Brian Toohey. Brain, the short ball to Shamey. Shamey Meehan. Shamey doing a bit of carrying now. Turns his man lovely. Inside to Charlie. Charlie and McNeil. And still Charlie. And Charlie is fouled. And he's hit. And he's everything. And it's a free for Donegal. Mr. McNeil acknowledges it. But he's being booked by referee Tommy Moran. The kick is taken too quickly there. The new regulations that the referees have had recently about personal fouls, jersey pulling and pulling down an opponent, and therefore Pádraig McNeil is booked there in this early incident. The linesman calling attention to something there as well. Charlie Mulgrew was a victim. Brian Toohey, the high ball in, and Anthony is going up there. Anthony's going up all the time. And it's a dangerous ball to Glancy as we're open down the middle there. In it comes Mickey McBurney and Tommy McDermott, who's having a tremendous game. He's followed out Paul Early to the centre half-forward position. Shamey Meehan. Shamey, lovely ball to Martin. Martin going right through. He must be held. He's let on, and he sends it over the bar. After 18 minutes. And McHugh is turning it on today. Another magnificent point. His third point of the game. And those of us who have watched games in Han and Tony and in Sandfield and places like this have come to expect this. But when somebody does it on All-Ireland final day, there's something special about it. Keeper Cunniff to take the kick out. Donegal 5, Roscommon 2.
Sorry.
McNeil being fouled there. Free for Roscommon. But Donegal have really gone into this game like a lion. Roaring, anxious, fighting for everything. And McHugh taking the scores so well. And the large Donegal crowd totally enraptured by this performance. Roscommon free is going in high. And Tommy McDermott in behind Paul Early. Paul gets the ball out this side. And it comes to corner forward Connellan. And Matt Gallagher goes up on top of him. And Matt's still at him. And he's tackling him hard. But he's not fouling him. And he still has it. And he gets it out there to Corcoran, who turns twice and then sends a ball harmlessly wide. A wide ball. 5-2. 20 minutes of the game gone. And they've been 20 vintage minutes for Donegal. Against the wind, which doesn't seem to be as strong as it was at the very beginning of the game. Matt Gallagher. Paul Hickey. Mickey McBrearty. Eunan Mack. Eunan Mack again. Paul Hickey. Paul Hickey for Roscommon. And the tackling is magnificent there by Donegal. But Tommy Moran rules, deems that that's a free for Roscommon. Anna Hooser Fad. Jantig Dunangal. Sochlihisho. Anyemert Guleiraku Chordeve. Kuig Funchaku. Ganig Roscommonia Birch. Agus gre hans de chulani ag Donegal nach worship. Martin beg magui gimmert sar chlihar fad le tri chulin an eidan na glihe moed isho. Sir hic ag ros comonian ish. Tic si ish daga hard. Agus skok niel si crin ta si mi crin it's gone wide. And that Roscommon attempt for a free has not worked. From right half forward Tom Corcoran. And now if Donegal one feels can keep this up to half-time, there could be scenes in the county tonight that haven't been seen for years and years. But it's early days and Roscommon beat Cork and Patrick McGroarty of Mount Charles, who's playing so well. And it comes out there now to the right corner forward. Broken down to Early. Early coming through. Early having a chance. He takes a shot. It's a point. And so it's 5-3 there. Roscommon, obviously their main threat is Paul Early, who's now, of course, centre-half forward, and Tommy McDermott has followed him out. Now there's a very strong shower blowing down the field, and it's very difficult against this wind. And look at Joyce. Joyce, beauty to Seamus Meehan, who's slipping. And Paul Carr has a chance there if he can open them up. Paul slips too. The condition's difficult. Paul, great ball, but it's just a bit short for Martin McHugh, who fights like anything. And Paul Carr is back there from Letterkenny. Paul, outside him is another Donegal man. He's overdoing it a bit there. Charlie Mulgrew, his clubmate's on it now. Charlie with a rain belting down. Charlie still going through. Four steps, Charlie. Too many, Charlie. Three out. Eamon Glancy in a hurry. Roscommon realising that the time is on Donegal's side. And the kick to be taken by the Roscommon right back, Gary Wynn. And if this commentary is biased, it's biased. Up goes Tommy McDermott, breaking the ball down. Matt Gallagher coming out along with a Roscommon man who slides 10 yards. He still has it. Matt fouls him. And Matt will be talking in there because Matt never stops talking. And he goes back there now. As Roscommon's marksman, Jimmy Conlon, having a shot at this from 53, 54 yards out. Dangerous ball. Fisted down and Donegal defender in there. Getting it out. It was Matt. And now it's Martin. And Martin, the good, sensible low ball. And Joyce slips, unfortunately. McNeil, one of Roscommon's good players. McNeil, the high ball again. A high, dangerous ball going all the way from 55 yards. But I think we needn't worry if Donegal can keep it like this until half-time. Things are looking well. The wind very strong at the moment, which is having a decided impact on the game. 24 minutes gone in the first half. 6 to survive to half-time. Mickey McBrearty. Joyce is going up for it there. Joyce tries to break it down. Good ball by Early. Coming through. Goalkeeper Kelly. His first touch. Good ball. Oh! A little bit short, but Brian Chewy does the covering. Brian sends it out to Matt. Matt. Good, sensible pass to Shamey Meehan. Brian is still running. Shamey takes his time. The low ball to McGroarty. McGroarty. Advantage given. Shamey Meehan. Lovely football. Brian to Charlie. Cut in, Charlie. Charlie will. He is cutting in. Charlie Mulgrew, that is. Slips again at a 50. Donegal playing beautiful, controlled, passing football there, knowing that the wind is strong, that the long ball into it is risky, and Charlie slipping again. The conditions, of course, underfoot, very, very difficult. Hard to realise, of course, when people are sitting watching this in the comfort of the Abbey Hotel or some of the other taverns scattered throughout the county, that this game is being played in difficult conditions with the wind, which has subsided just for a minute, just to give Martin a chance. And Martin runs back about 20 yards, and this is going to be a mighty kick. And so she is, right in there, broken down, but Roscommon take it out. And out it comes to who? To Martin McHugh. Well fielded. Martin going on another solo. He's held. He's still going. He sends it out to Charlie. Charlie, who isn't getting the breaks today. Boot goes in there. Paul Carr. Shamey Meehan. The cross. In they go. Up go the fists and it's wide. And so as we enter the last 5 minutes, or 4 minutes of this first half, we're so satisfied. It's 5-4 for Donegal. And it's not just that they're in the lead, but that they're playing so well, and that if these chances had been taken, it could have been 5-4. But we're happy as it is. Cunniff taking the kick out for Roscommon. Middle of the field, and Malloy goes as high. But it's not gathered up, and it's Tommy McDermott. Tommy again. Really making life difficult there. Fine shoulder by Brian Chewy. Brian tripped. And that'll be a booking. Because that's the rule. Yes, Tommy Moran, who is refereeing this game tremendously well, taking there the Roscommon right half forward, Tom Corcoran, and booking him. A fortnight ago, that would not have been a booking offence. But today, because of the change of regulations at the beginning of the National League, it is a booking offence. Matt Gallagher taking the kick into Patrick McGroarty. It's grooves off Matt's boot. Patrick doesn't get it. Patrick, one of the people whose selection would have been quibbled, but on today's performance there should be no quibbles about Patrick's performance. Ball running through to Joyce. Joyce McMullen. The ball again coming away here with the wind, which is becoming more of a cross. And the only thing we don't want now is this wind dropping. The line ball for Roscommon going into Paul Early, who seems to field now. And it's Joyce hacking at him there. But the referee gives a free to Roscommon. A foul by Joyce. Donegal realising now that if they can hold Roscommon for the next 2 minutes, or hold them even to a point, it'll be level at half time. And then, with this wind, there'll be a chance of taking this All-Ireland. Marty Shanahan. Paul Early going up, fisting the ball. Let it go, it's going wide. And so far, Donegal seem to have a better balanced 15. Roscommon having very outstanding performers in centre-half McNeil, in Paul Early, in Eamon Glancy, in bits and pieces. But generally, the Donegal team having many heroes. As Matt Gallagher, no, it's Mickey McBrearty, these two Donegal cornerbacks of similar build. A push on the back. No, Tommy McDermott. Tommy, in goes a tackle there. Mickey McBrearty, what a good reader of the game Mickey McBrearty is. Mickey gets it away to Martin McHugh. And one big run would do Martin. And Martin is carrying it. and Martin really giving the Roscommon defence something to worry about. Out comes the Roscommon left back there, gets the ball, left footed downfield, up goes Donal Reid. It's Anthony Malloy, and Anthony does the hard work. It's still Anthony fighting for it there. Three Donegal men there, Roscommon man on the ground, and he's fouled. A free in for a foul on Eamon McManus, and so a chance for Roscommon to equalise before half time. We're virtually in at half time. It's the last minute of the first half, 5-4. Jimmy Conlon equalises. And so the score is now 5 points each as we come near half-time. One can notice that the Donegal following here is much, much louder than the Roscommon. The kind of shouting and ovation that greets the scores is not at all even. It's half-time and it's 5 points each, and there will be a rousing ovation for this Donegal team at half-time. For both teams, but particularly for the Donegal men. And out they come now for the end of a fine first half. Patrick McGroarty, Seamus Meehan, Sean Boner, Paul Carr, Joyce McMullen, Brian Suey, Porrig Gallagher, Charlie Mulgrew. The Roscommon men coming now. Then Anthony Malloy, Matt Gallagher, Derry people.
That's part of what you said.
What?
Was not prepared off.
Couple of four grand.
When?
I had a stare before you.
At full time, the main gate, what? All the gates will be open.
Where's the dog?
No, it's okay. No, we asked just for your cooperation. Coming through the gate there.
And we asked people not to jump the wires, etc. Yeah. So cooperate with the steward.
What?
As far as possible, all the gates will be open.
Immediately.
After the full time whistle. Now, a purse has been handed in, and the owner can have the same by coming to the microphone stand after the game. Currently, Spawn Jeffel, ready on the guest of her, and Shock off, Caradrum Rook, you. We also welcome press, both at local and national level.
And the camera there, looking up at the dressing rooms here, we see, or the press facilities here up on top, the radio and the Gaelic commentary team, Paul O'Gallagher and Freddie Call, and down below, and some Donegal fans up there behind, coming from parts of the county. You see Colm Murray sitting in the corner there of the press box. Murray, whose Chinnishi reports will hopefully next Friday, when the Democrat and the People's Press come out, be featuring a Donegal All-Ireland victory, having their cup of tea here in Carrick-on-Shannon. And as we look around here, Donegal fans very contented with the first half. A first half that began with a great point by Martin McHugh. Roscommon then came with 2 points by Jimmy Connellan, and then by Marty Shanahan. This was followed by a point by Porrig Gallagher to leave it 2 each.
From Eamon Kern. He's going to sing for us Mary from Dunlow and the West Side.
Donal Reid pointed for Donegal. The spouting will go, you'll fall. The substitutes down there kicking the ball in and out. as we listen to the singer in the background singing the Mary from Dunloe. The Donegal subs today, Sylvester Maguire of the Erua Club, who will almost certainly be coming onto this team before the day is out. Marty Shovlin of Duncan Ely, John McGowan of St. Knowles, Marty Carlin of Killigordon, John O'Donnell of Glenties, Maeve Connell, Donny McColl of Ardara, and Maurice Carr of Kilcar. Pardon? I'd say so. The strains of the West awake now, representing Roscommon. Donegal's first half scorers: Martin McHugh, 3 points. Padraig Gallagher, 1 point. Donal Reid, 1 point. For Roscommon, Marty Shanner and Padraig McNeil, the two halfbacks, a point each. Jimmy Conlon, 2 points, and Paul Early, 1 point. And so there's half an hour to go in this game, and things are going very well for Donegal, but it's all to do now in the second half. We all remember the day Donegal played Longford, how at half-time, when the Cork-Roscommon game result came in, it looked as if Cork would be the final opponents as they were walking through Roscommon. But in the second half, Roscommon came back and took a great victory in the last minute with a goal by forward Tom Corcoran. So Donegal would need to avoid any kind of complacency or thinking that this game was won. They have the advantage of a wind, the wind that rises and falls. And there, down in front of us, we see some of the Donegal people from all over the county. Here beside us we have Patsy Gilday, one of the long-standing stalwarts of Ardara, so we'll ask Patsy for an opinion on the game so far. Juan Gilday, what are you going to say? Do you think they're going to win it, Patsy?
Oh, I think so. They're doing very well. And young McHugh's having a great game in the forward, and some very nice points. And generally they're doing well, and I hope they win it. I think they will.
And who would you pick out, apart from Martin McHugh, in that first half performance, Patsy?
Patrick McGorty and both midfielders. Generally, the whole team is on a whole. They're playing very well now.
You're quite happy with the Ardara man?
Yeah, playing very well. They're going high. They're playing very well.
And I'd say that Patsy's sentiments there will be echoed by most Donegal people here at the match. Out of there, quick. Where's Anthony Harkin? Oh, Anthony Harkin standing down there with that Manchester United headgear in front of him. Anthony, trainer of the Ardara team, with Patsy Harkin there beside him. And they're coming back onto the field for the second half, anxious to get down to it.
Have you your phone cross pack?
No, I don't. What are they down here?
Oh, you can, I.
And so as Donegal go back on the field for the second half, there's Tom Conaghan moving out there again now. Certainly now it would appear on the threshold of something wonderful. Down the decades and down the years, people have longed to see the day that Donegal would take an All-Ireland. People in the 20s and 30s and 40s that produced great players, the Erua teams of the 30s, the Dunloe teams of the early 30s, the Gaedore teams of the 40s. And then the 50s and the 60s, the late 60s, the early 60s with the McCools great teams and the St. Joseph's teams of the late 60s and 70s. And then the Southwest domination later on in that decade. But never before was a Donegal team so near an All-Ireland title. And out come Roscommon for the beginning of the second half. Not much delaying by either team at half-time. awaiting now the arrival of the referee. There's going to be a substitute on the Roscommon team. Number 19, John Kelly of Elphin, would appear to be coming in. Roscommon. Roscommon have kept Paul Early out at centre half forward. Number 19 Kelly, big tall lad, getting his physical jerks in before the beginning of the second half. Looking round the Donegal team, it seems to be the same. Mick Kelly in goals, McBrearty from Donegal Town, Donal Reid's now at fullback, Matt Gallagher, Eunan McIntyre, Tommy McDermott, Brian Suey, Joyce McMullen and Anthony Malloy, Martin McHugh, Charlie Mulgrew, Shamie Meehan, Porrick Gallagher, Paul Carr and Patrick McGroarty. Ian Gallagher, who at a distance from us here look alike, their fair hair. It's 3:44, nearly a quarter to four on this October 17, 1982. It's the beginning of the second half. The teams are level. Referee Tommy Moran of Leitrim throws it in, and Anthony Malloy of Ardara sends it down to Shamie Meehan, and Shamie slips. Shanahan for Roscommon. Shanahan moving upfield. Donegal must be careful in the first few minutes of the second half. Corner forward Conlon and Matt Gallagher. Conlon still on the ball, followed by Matt. Still hassled by Matt. Still Conlon. Matt trying to get it there, very indecisive. It comes out to a Roscommon player, moving over to make an angle for himself, centering it there. Another Donegal slip, but is going to be booted out by Anthony Malloy, who sends us attacking, pushing it back on Charlie. Referee far away, and it's McNeil coming through again. One of the tough struggles here, Mulgrew McNeil. The high ball in, up goes Tommy. Early gets it, early turns, early shoots, and it's Mickey McBrearty, as so often, to Brian Suey. And now let's settle down. Brian making room, then taking the kick. But it's a Roscommon man there, Rogers. Rogers sending the ball in low this time. Nice touch outside on this left-hand side to Colin, to centre-half forward Eamon McManus. Eamon McManus on a run in. Donal Reid getting it away from him, and Donal does well to Brian Chewy. Referee allows play on, but a Roscommon coming out with a new determination now. Shanahan still. Shanahan inside, but it's read there by Tommy McDermott. And Tommy McDermott is emerging from the beginning as a hero, one of the heroes. It must be a free for Donegal, surely. No, the referee will probably throw it up. There seem to be a boot or two going in there. McDermott's on the ground. He would certainly seem to have got a boot in the back there, but the referee throws it in, and McDermott is still down, and Donegal must win this one. And Donegal do win this. And it's Joyce sending a long ball downfield, well taken by McNeil. McNeil being held there by Shamie Meehan, fouled by Shamie Meehan, by Charlie Mulgrew. Free. It was Charlie Mulgrew there. Shamie Meehan wouldn't do a thing like that. And so it's a free kick for Roscommon, taken by one of their stalwart centre halfback, Padraig McNeil of the Roscommon Gaels. Padraig kick upfield, and up goes Anthony Block down there to Mickey. Mickey gets it before it touches the ground to Joyce. Joyce now, come on, a long ball right through Carr, coming for it, but is well taken by the Roscommon right back Gary Wynn, team captain. Low ball into Glancy and Mulgrew. Glancy, right footed ball in there. Mickey McBrearty is surely held, but Mickey, held as he is, gets the ball out. Well spotted there by Tommy Moran, and Mickey McBrearty having another wonderful game for the county here, reminiscent of his county final display. Donal Reid for the free. A shaky start to the second half by Donegal, as Roscommon have come out very determined and very spirited, and a reminder to Donegal that this game is by no means won and that there is no need for complacency. Donal Reid, Donal's ball going high there. Roscommon man going up for it. Porrick Gallagher fails to take it cleanly. Roscommon left back Gay Collins fouled. Come back, he says to Porrick Gallagher. Sylvester Maguire has got rid of his tracksuit at this stage, and that will be the next Donegal change. Gay Collins' kick comes into the middle of the field. Anthony Malloy is going up there, and Anthony breaks it down. Can a Donegal man get in there? No, Roscommon are getting the breaks early on. Mulgrew doing a bit of fighting there now. But again, it's the Roscommon right half forward, Corcoran. Corcoran. Mulgrew. Mulgrew. The long ball for Paul Carr. It breaks inside to Porrig Gallagher, going right through to the Roscommon goalie, Kniff, and it's gone wide. And so, a promising beginning by Roscommon to the second half. The first few minutes of it being more Roscommon than Donegal. 4 minutes of it gone at this stage. Keeper Kniff. Out she comes. Nobody going up but Roscommon men, and it's Glancy. And so often a sterling first half display takes an awful lot out of a team. Eunan Mack running there with sub Kelly. Kelly on it. Kelly still on it. Held twice, getting the advantage, getting the ball through there. Matt Gallagher with Connellan. Connellan on the ball. Matt still holding on to him. Connellan still on it. Still on it. Good ball inside. And McKee again reads it. And Eunan Mack slips there. Comes out to left half forward Kelly. Kelly moving the ball in. Good ball. So Tommy McDermott breaking it down from early. Coming out again for Roscommon. It's a right half forward Corcoran. Or left half forward Paul Hickey. Hickey's ball is good. Up goes early and down comes early. And early is the ball. And early gets it out to Eamon McManus. Eamon's kick is blocked down. This defensive work is good again. Eunan Mack trying to keep it in. Eunan Mack succeeds. Eunan Mack the short ball to Donal Reid. Donal trying to get round. Oh, lovely. Sends a ball out to Joyce. And now Joyce, a bit of carrying. A good ball inside to Porrick. Come on, Porrick. Porrick gets it. Lovely ball to Martin. But no, a little bit in front of him. But Martin is fighting, and Martin fought inside him. Can he keep it in? No, it's gone out. And so it's a line ball for Roscommon. There by Martin McHugh. And so, the first 5 minutes of the second half, Donegal seeming to be a bit lacking in the full forward line in the beginning of the second half. Up goes Anthony Malloy, but it's well taken down there by Paul Early, who's certainly Roscommon's hero. Paul sends it in, it's a slip there, and Mickey Brerty. Mickey taking it easy there, left footed ball inside to Charlie Mulgrew. Ball breaks through to Paul Carr, taken down. And now is when we start praying that Martin's boots that were so accurate in the first half maintain that form, because of the winning of this game could be on that left foot of Martin McHugh of Bavan Kilcar. Yes! Yes, indeed, Martin. The flags on the show tell the story. Donegal have gone ahead. Six minutes of the second half gone. Martin McHugh the scorer. Martin's fourth point. And it's refreshing to see Martin totally accurate today. Kniff with the kick out. And now listen to Donegal. The whole field is with us. Tommy McDermott is going up, but Big Malloy goes higher. And out it comes. There's a scramble. Roscommon trying to break out. Out comes Brian Chewy and Matt Gallagher and Joyce McMullen. They're all anxious. Joyce's kick is broken down. Glancy, the long ball into the space. Danger! Mickey McBerty going back. Mickey covers well. Mickey sells a dummy. And Mickey places Donal Reid. And Donal grabs it out of the sky. And Donal then places Eunan McIntyre. And Eunan McIntyre places Porrig Gallagher. And Porrig takes it out of the air. And Porrig looks around. And Porrig takes a couple of steps. And Paddy McGrorty is fighting for it there. And it breaks to Mulgrew. And Mulgrew must be held. And Mulgrew is still going. And Mulgrew screws off his boot. But they're playing well again. And it's 6-5. Again, the danger in these situations is these breakaways there. Mickey McBerty, as so often he does, covering that time and clearing the danger. And one field, another point or two, and we're sailing. Kniff again, busy man. Anthony Malloy, you get Brishan Shin Wissa, Ikfarasos Common, you get Chick Shema Haratiu Show, Akatan Shin, Show Yamak Mulan, Tashig Joyce, the Bird Charter, Tashig Joyce Gafol, you get Kurin Shay Stockig, Paul McGillihara, Paul McGillihara, Tashig Gafol, Tashir Hitoy, Tashig Erish, Paul, and Federalisha Kurishta,
And will fa John to Kurnish Takishale, Aktashir for Eligus Seer kick, Kikamakatam, the Roscommon. Roscommon man down injured there, number 7 man is Tiernan. He seems to be okay. The Roscommon tackling very good there, Donegal forwards finding it difficult to get room enough to get their shots in. One feels that they're going to nail them, they're going to nail them now. Cuniff again. Up goes Anthony Malloy, it seems to be him again. This time, another Donegalman, a lot of holding there, and it's a chance. Joyce, fouled on the 50. And Martin McHugh, pulling up the left sock. Sylvester Maguire is in the game. Sylvester Maguire from the Erua club, Ballyshannon, is coming into the Donegal team as he has in the Ulster final. And it's a little bit maybe hard if Patrick McGroarty is making his exit, because he certainly gets a round of applause that he deserves. Patrick McGroarty of Mount Charles has done his bit, and he has done it marvellously. And now he is the experienced Maguire goes in, Martin McHugh. Look at that! Yes, Martin! That is the tell of stories that he spent kicking balls over the bar in Tony and Fintra. Wasn't it worth it? McHugh 5. Donegal 7, Roscommon 5. And there's a thrilling, throbbing excitement around this field. Out she comes. And up goes Joyce. But it's taken down by McNeil, one of Roscommon's stars. He's fouled. Sylvester seems to have got straight in full forward. Paul Carr seems to have come out to the left corner forward position where Patrick McGroarty was. And Malloy is leaping and leaping, and it's Paul Early, and Paul Early is dangerous. And Paul gets the ball into the open space there, away out, where out goes Corcoran. Corcoran being chased by Shamie Meehan. Corcoran still has it. Corcoran still has it, trying to move around. Being hassled by Meehan, the ball goes in there, and it goes into the Roscommon centre fielder, Rogers. He takes the shot. Kelly gets it. Kelly gets it out. Does the adequate. Charlie Mulgrew. Charlie. Beauty. Sylvester. Come on, Sylvester. Sylvester held. And he's held where Martin can kick. And Martin is running over. Good ball there by Mulgrew. It's sharp and accurate. And Martin McHugh, 10 on his back. The man from Kilcar. Marcin Beg Muggy. Sean Seliga. Dunanga. Lochar Cool Chumtasi. As again, the defence there, building on good tackling as Rogers had a chance there. And the crowd is behind them. Up he comes. And this is the first one that Martin has sent wide. I suppose, understandably so, from the left-hand side, not so suitable to the left-footed kicker. Cuniff taking the kick out. Donegal, 7-5 ahead in an All-Ireland final. Cuniff. Out she comes, towards the left, and up goes Donal Reid, breaking it down. Paul Carr fighting for it there. Paul still fighting for a Donegal ball. And Martin is going out again, though it's a way out now on his left. Asks the line, no, the linesman says no, the linesman is going to place it. And this time it's not round the corner, it's straight ahead or run there by Paul Carr, drawing them out. In she goes. Ah, great ball. Carr fisted, Gallagher fisted down, but Roscommon are coming out with it. Porrig Gallagher still fighting for it. Porrig going down for it. Porrig bounces it. Cuts inside. The left foot. Great point! Minutes gone in the second half, and the Ballantraman, the student at Thomond College of Education, taking a great point there. It's 8-5, and we're driving on. Out she comes. This side of the field, it'll go out. It should go out. No, well kept in there. Has it gone out of this stage? It has. It's a Donegal ball, and it's where Martin will be on his left, will be taking the kick. And there's that massive, throbbing, wonderful, emotional excitement here as Martin McHugh takes the kick inside the 50. In it goes, curling in, breaking down, and Roscommon, fair play to them, are defending with greatness. Anthony Malloy breaking the ball down to Brian Chewy, and the captain of the team from Erua takes the left-footed kick in, and she looks good, and she's gone wide. A good effort there by Brian Chewy. And Donegal, who are sweeping ahead in waves of grand football, but are still only that goal ahead. And now what it takes is to carry on the drive. This one comes out, and up goes Sylvester Maguire, and Sylvester breaks it down to Paul Carr, and Paul trying to get room, and he can't, and therefore he gives it out to Sylvester, and Sylvester's shot goes wide, and it's a pity. There could be points we could be doing with at the end of the day, but things are going well. Malloy going up every time there. Out comes Cuniff's kick. Shamie Meehan. But it's Malloy again breaking it down. This time a Roscommon man comes out with it. It's the Roscommon right back, Gary Wynn, the team captain. On it, two Donegal men round it. He goes over the line. It's a line ball for Donegal. And it speaks volumes for the determination and the tenacity of this team. Once a Roscommon man pounces, he's surrounded. Another long, mighty kick from Brian Chewy. Up the go, breaks down, and is gathered by McNeil. And were McNeil not there, Roscommon would certainly not be here anymore. McNeil coming out with it. The ball comes out, and it seems to be Donegal men everywhere. Brian Chewy again. No, it's not. Donal Reid. Donal again. Donal trying to get room. Comes out, and it's four Donegal men around one Roscommon man. This time it comes to Donal Reid again. Donal trying to get the room. He gets the ball inside to Paul Carr, but Roscommon defending with great valiant determination there. McNeil, does he hold it to it too long? He's pushed in the back eventually as he tries to get rid of it. We're into the last quarter. Donegal are 3 points ahead. They've owned the last 10 minutes of this game. Pat Dury taking the kick for Roscommon, who are defending resolutely. And again it's Malloy. He seems to be going up there all the time, doing barrels of work. Roscommon coming out there, right back, Gay Wynn, a good game he's having too. Gay coming out again, and still coming out, and good hassling by Paul Carr, and now the two-letter Kenny men around him. And now it's Shamie Meehan breaking it down. Get down on it, Shamie. He does. He swings around. He can't get the kick in. He does eventually block down Donegal ball, must be. Yes. Brian Chewy. One feels another point even to get that four-point lead. And there's the same throbbing excitement in all hearts. Paul Carr taking it cleanly there. Paul, capable player, inside. Slipped by Sylvester. Oh, McNeil felt that. Very good refereeing today. Pory Gallagher trying to slow it down. Eamon Glancy doesn't like it. Cool it, says Tommy Moran. Tremendously well handled this game altogether. Pat Dury. And so hopes now that the fitness and the training and the hard work in Tona Willie and in McCool Park is going to show. Malloy, the long ball in a battle there, but it's gathered again, out it breaks. Was it picked up? No, and it's a Roscommon man coming out, stopped by Martin McHugh. Martin keeps hassling and Martin keeps running, and Martin might eventually end up getting it. No, it's another Roscommon man on the ball. He's tackled there, gets the ball out to the left here to Paul Hickey, the danger of the counter break, followed by Eunan Mac, and still followed by Eunan Mac, and still followed by Eunan Mac. And Eunan, who has tackled so much, so determined, breaking down now, and it comes to Marty Shanahan. Shanahan followed by Meehan. McBrearty gathers it cleanly, and look at that. Look at that. But look at that. And Maguire. And Maguire to Mulgrew. And Mulgrew is finding this McNeil a handful. But he's keeping chasing and he fouls him. He doesn't, says the ref. And out comes Meehan. And still Meehan. And still Meehan. He's waiting. He holds onto it too long. There was no need to wait. And there has been football here that Donegal teams have hardly ever produced. Perhaps never on such a big occasion have they risen to the occasion so magnificently as these men out here. The composure and the coolness there of Mickey McBrearty under pressure. Donal Reid going up, but Malloy goes up. And Malloy will be... They had an election in Ardara for Lord Mayor, but one feels Anthony Malloy would be a unanimous choice, no matter how much money anybody else would collect after this particular day, of the next 12 minutes of this game allow Donegal to come home. Roscommon make a substitution. Another point, we feel. Matt Gallagher. Breaking. And Roscommon once again. How well they have defended in the second half. And the Donegal forward line could be making more of an impact. This ball from Chewy is aimless and goes wide. And it's still 8-5. And the main thing now is that there's no frustration. Let nothing creep into the game. Cool it. Wait to this point that puts us four clear. Kniff with a kick out. And it's Jamie Meehan going up, fisting the ball down. Good ball chance. And it's well cleared. Meehan going in again. Well cleared again. And out it comes now to another Roscommon defender, Shanahan. Shanahan to McNeil. McNeil coming away with the ball. And this Roscommon defence certainly has earned many plaudits today. And this is Early. And Early's kick is blocked down by McDermott. And McDermott, the ball is going out. Let it go. Will it go? Yes, it goes. And it's a Donegal ball. And every Donegal man, from Malin Head to Malin Moor, playing every minute of this game. And now the roar goes up. And behind them. And the Ballantra man. In it goes. And it breaks to another Roscommon man. And this time it's Rogers, a midfielder, and he's carrying it. And perhaps, and look at Matt Gallagher from Ballantra. And look at that for coolness. And look at McBrearty. McBrearty kicks and sends the ball in there for a line ball for Roscommon. And the whole population of Donegal that's gathered here today, hoping and praying that nothing unusual happens, that Roscommon don't steal it, because it would be a daylight robbery. Malloy breaking it down, and they must be perhaps running a little bit out of steam, and who could blame them? They've fought so hard. 1, 2, 3, 4. Roscommon still going and still hassling are the Donegal boys. The ball comes into Eamon McManus. Eamon McManus has it. Eamon is trying to make room, and Eamon's jersey is pulled, and if the jersey is pulled, it's a free for Roscommon. And this game is still alive, and it's annoying, and it's niggling, and it's throbbing excitement. And it's taken on the line there. And it's cleared out by Matt Gallagher. And Matt Gallagher's kick goes over the line. And that Roscommon free is missed. And we're 9 minutes away from an All-Ireland title. And Roscommon now coming with a burst in this game. And the Donegal defence so far holding firm. In she goes. And who's there? It's Malloy from Ardara. And he's fouled. And he leaves it down. And if there are shades of Jack O'Shea there, then they're there. Mickey McBrearty. Out she comes. It's Roscommon men. And it's the Roscommon sub going up for it. Tries to get it in. And the Donegal is Malloy again. Comes out to Marty Shanahan. Shamie Meehan tries to get it. Marty Shanahan sending the ball in there. Out goes Matt Gallagher. Grand shoulder. No, says the ref. He says it wasn't a shoulder. Oh! And it'll be a throw-up now as the referee, Marty Shanahan, who may already have been booked, he may not have been booked. The situation was that there was a foul given against Matt Gallagher, what would seem like a good shoulder. Matt didn't hear the whistle, carried on, and Marty Shanahan, who had heard the whistle, a bit frustrated by Matt carrying on, went in very, very, very dangerously indeed. And that will mean that it will be a throw-in, presumably,
between two players. Matt is down injured there. Matt, grittiest, hardest fighting men on the Donegal team, who have brought new pride to the Ballantra club. Tommy Moran does the right thing. Tommy Moran throws it up. Matt Gallagher hobbles back. Matt Gallagher is not going to miss the last 8 minutes of this game. And who's that? You would guess nearly. And you're right. And the ball goes astray. And it's number 12 there, Paul Hickey. And Shamie Meehan in now. And there's so much determination and there's so much fighting spirit there. As Roscommon come, as they came against Cork, looking to steal it this time. Marty Shanahan, in goes the ball. And it's again another Donegal man, Gallagher. Matt, the ball to Sylvester. Take it, Sylvester. He goes down. He goes down again and it's breaking loose. And it's a throw up, I think, between two of them. A lot of throwing up here between four or five or six of them. Breaks down again and it's Donal Reid. Donal Reid getting it away there and Donal Reid going to get it. And there's fight in there again. And this Matt Gallagher man is now emerging as another hero. There are so many. Donal. Lovely. Come on, over. Over with it. And it's gone wide from Pádraig Gallagher, looking for the point. But at least it brings play down to our end of the field. 6 minutes away we are. Get Cunniff taking the kick out for Roscommon, the St. Bridget's keeper. Up they go. And it's Malloy. And Malloy sends it and it goes away, way, way into the trees, but it's all right. And it comes out again to Cunniff. And this must be the greatest display in the footballing life of one Anthony Malloy. Cunniff with a kick out. And there's well taken there by Dury. Dury going away with it there. Charlie Mulgrew's with him. Charlie pushes. Dury still free for Roscommon. We're 5 minutes away and there'll be five of the longest minutes in the history of the county. And this one comes into the middle of the field and it's Joyce trying to go up, doesn't quite make it. But it breaks well for him and Joyce now trying to make it again and this time Joyce does. Joyce is fouled and it's on halfway and it's great. Joyce McMullen for Masters and McHugh. And McHugh may be a little bit ambitious, but it's on halfway. 2 yards inside the Roscommon half. Martin McHugh, who has scored 5 points. And what about 70 yards? She goes 60 anyway. Breaks in there. And again, the Roscommon cornerbacks who have done heroics in there today. Shamie Meehan fighting. Fighting like Meehan never did before. Pádraig Gallagher fighting. And whose is it? Leitrimann says it's a Roscommon ball. And it's the Roscommon man taking it out. We're only 3 minutes away. And it's a Donegal ball now. And who's going to take this one and what we would do with this point? Because we're sitting on this 3-point lead for an agonising quarter of an hour. Martin McHugh going to take it. Again, not his suitable side. Martin, is he going to set it? No, he's not. Because it might be thrown in. Who wants it thrown in? Come on, Martin. Into the centre it goes. Up goes Sylvester. Breaks down. Still Sylvester. Come on. Yes, well taken there by Yunan Mack. Yunan tends to throw it back. Still has it. Give it somewhere, Yunan. Still has it. He loses it. And it's Zeman or Rogers. Rogers, a long ball up. Come on, Tommy McDermott. Tommy comes and Tommy goes down. Paul Early on top of him. And Tommy does so well. And he sends it to the Bundoran man. And it's nice to see Bundoran and Ballyshannon and everywhere else. As again Roscommon come. This kick comes across. Come on, Shamie Meehan from Four Masters. And Marty Shanahan. And Shamie. And Shamie. And who got it? Who got it? He's going to throw it in. He can't make up his mind. Who can? There's only two. Martin. McHugh of Kilcar. McHugh. Still McHugh. He's a right foot too. He sends it in.
Up they go. It breaks down to Maguire. Maguire! No, it's gone wide. One and a half. One and a half. Cunniff to take the kick out. And it looks like history is being made if we just had a few more fighting minutes. Malloy of Ardara. And Malloy is fouled. And this is Anthony Malloy's greatest hour. Martin McHugh from 60 yards is going to have another kick at it here. We've 1 minute to go in the game. And it's a wonderful, history-making, marvellous day for Donegal football. Martin taking his time. Tommy Moran says, don't take so much. We're on the edge of history. And these boys deserve it, as does Tom Conaghan. McHugh's 60-yard kick. It's a goal! It's a goal! Well, it's disallowed, but who cares? It's a goal! No! No, he's running for the other flag. And there's not even half a minute left. Square ball. Out it comes. Come on, let fate not be cruel now. Kelly or somebody getting it. But it's another Donegal man. Ah, good man yourself, Meehan. And it's still Meehan, and he's fouled, and this must be it. And every heart is beating. And it looks like it. And they've fought and they've trained since away back last April. And this is the fruit of the training of Town of Willie. And there would be nothing more suitable than that Martin McHugh would kick the winning, final, glorious, magnificent point. Somebody's too near, but that's fine because it's all over. McHugh of Kilcar. Ha ha! On the line. Out it comes. We won it! We won it! We won it! We've done it! We've done it! Hurry, Pete. Tom Conaghan. Donald Monaghan. Mickey Laverty. And then the boys. Michael Kelly. Mickey McBrady. Sean Boner, Matt Gallagher, Eunan McIntyre, Tommy McDermott, Brian Tuohy, Anthony Malloy, Joyce McMullen, Martin McHugh with 5 points, Charlie Mulgrew, Shimmy Meehan, Padraig Gallagher, Paul Carr, Patrick McGrorty, Donal Reid, and Sylvester Maguire. The score is 8-5, and they're being carried in one marvellous sweeping swamp of glorious excitement as Donegal have won the All-Ireland. There's Eunan Mac sky high, and Joyce and McHugh, and they're all heroes. And of Malloy, and listen to that. And isn't it great to have lived, to have seen this day? Eunan Mac and McHugh and Joyce and Shovlin are up there. And the rest are, and Reid is now up. And Meehan is up. And Porrig Gallagher is up. And this is the greatest day. And now Malloy is up. And Paul Carr is up. And Mulgrew is up. And McDermott is up. And Chewy is up. They're all up. And McRorty is up. And Eunan Mack. And they might have a presentation in a while.
The chairman of the Ulster Council, President of the Ulster Council, Peter Hart.
Peter Hart wants to present the cup. And I'm sure it's a very happy occasion for Tyrone man, Peter Hart.
It was a hard game throughout, like the pitch is fierce heavy, you know. It was a heavy goal, but the first break in the first half,
you think it was your own kind of display ever?
There you go. You want to give Donegal a bit to do?
Donegal team manager Tom Conaghan, what a big day it is for Tom, the man who steered Donegal Town, the Four Masters Club, to their first championship victory in Donegal for 58 years, and now is a man at the helm, along with Mickey Lafferty and Donal Monaghan, of this Donegal under 21 team. Tom standing there along with Donal Monaghan with the... So the years of waiting are over, the years that many people long for. The day has arrived now. Donegal in an All-Ireland final. Under 21 out there in the middle of the field. Donal Reid and Anthony Malloy. One of the famous Malloy brothers of Ardara, whose brothers Lamptey and Connie and Frank have distinguished themselves with the Ardara club. And it's the younger member now, Anthony. And Martin from Kilcar starting us off in great style with that point.
Kilcar. Paul, is Paul brought down? No. Referee says no, and it's a controlled football. And substitute Donal Reid immediately making an impact on Patrick McGroarty, is in a bit of bother there as he comes out. But McHugh's on song. Glancy, as we're open down the middle, and Fintran and Tony and in Sandfield and places like this have come to expect this, but when somebody does it on All-Ireland final day, there's something special about it. Keeper Cuniff to take the kick out.
Going to the field
for the second half, anxious to get down to it.
No, I don't.
One of them is down here.
Oh, you can.